Hello and welcome to the Overly Animated Podcast, where we take animation seriously. We talk everything animation here, including Ruby, which we'll be getting into right now. I'm Andy Potter, and I'm joined today by a lot of co-hosts. We're going to be playing some more D&D in the world of Ruby. We're going to continue our campaign of the Scourge of Mistral, but before we get there,
Scourge of Mistral.
Thank part two.
Yeah.
You can find more about this podcast at overlyanimated.com. You can subscribe to us on iTunes at overlyanimated.com/iTunes or on YouTube at youtube.com/overlyanimated. So with that said, I will introduce our players and then give you all a recap of what happened last time. So first up, we have Dylan Heisen.
Hi, I'm Moon. I'm back. I'm really excited to get back into. We met some guys. We're gonna do some stuff. Yeah, let's go.
I forgot your voice. Next, we have Beatrice Murad.
Hi, I'm Kane.
That's it.
Kane, you sound tired.
Well, after the last time, I'm really tired.
I guess we are picking up right away. Okay.
We have Alex Bodia.
Azure Slate, greetings.
Hi.
Oh, I already know you guys. Okay.
Hello, annoying sun boy. How are you?
I'm Moon. I'm not Sun.
Oh, yeah. Whatever.
What's your guy's name again? I forgot.
Oh my god. We have Haley Davers.
Opal here.
Thanks, Opal. And we have Ali Martin.
Harmony Rin.
Thank you.
Honestly, trying to remember the name of the Grimm.
Oh, Ro, yeah.
Russ.
My buddy Russ.
Somewhere. Have you ever decided what Russ looks like?
He's a very large dog.
He's a blob
figure. Okay.
Oh, man. So yeah, if you guys are listening to this part, listeners, make sure you listen to part one because we have already played an entire session and this is going to be a continuation of that. And with that said, I think I'm going to give you guys a recap of what our heroes did last time, and we're just going to pick it up right from there. When we last saw our heroes, they were in the town of Ramshorn, and they were cleaning up some Grimm and helping a town. When they returned, the entire town had burned down. The party attempted to save people and try to figure out what had happened, and it wasn't entirely clear. You didn't get a solid answer, but you didn't see it with your own eyes, but people told you that it seemed to be the White Fang that had done this, or bandits, or some kind of humanoid thing, not Grimm, but you're not 100% sure who did this. But before you could really investigate any further, the town was again attacked by some Beowulfs and a Nevermore, which you guys successfully defeated. You then found out that the elder of the town had been taking Faunuses into his house and essentially torturing / killing them, which is not good. But you let the town, I think, worry about that punishment. And then afterwards, you rested while Kane rested off her injuries from fighting the Nevermore. You guys then rested the night, woke up, and met some hippies. These hippies.
Excuse me, they're musicians. They're hot. they have perfected their craft. Show them some respect.
You actually have not heard them play music, so you do not know how good these.
Oh, but they're carrying large musical instruments, so they obviously have put some effort into this.
For all we know, those could be their weapons. Probably they are.
I hope they're also instruments.
Considering the show, they're definitely also guns or something.
Yep.
A guitar, a laser shooting guitar. That makes sense.
Anyways, the musicians you met on they were coming to the town of Ramshorn to just be musicians, play music, try to earn some money. But it seemed that the whole town was burned down. They were just kind of passing through, and they introduced themselves to you as Dandy, short for Dandelion, who is a violin player. He's kind of like a pretty boy kind of look going on, but I mean, everyone in Ruby's hot. We have Mist, whose gender is unclear. They are covered completely head to toe in like clothes, not unlike your own party member. Sorry, Haley, Opal. Not unlike Opal.
I missed that detail last time.
Completely completely covered in clothes. It's not like a similar look as you, but similarly, their entire body is covered.
I'm going to be investigating.
Okay. And lastly, there's Fleur, similarly spelled to the Harry Potter character Fleur, who plays the flute. She is also attractive, but again, I don't think that needs to be said.
It's an assumed fact.
I'll also say that Kane, you have not tried to hit on Fleur yet.
Can we? All right, sure.
You then decided, hey, these three are heading to the next town of Green Grove, and we'll go with them. And so you took to the road with these musicians. It was about a 1 or 2 day travel, and you arrived in Green Grove, a small town nestled between some mountains. And these mountains are part of the range that surrounds Haven Academy, but you're nowhere near Haven. These mountains just connect to the same mountain range. But
this is new now. We've transitioned into new information.
Yes. Or information that was rushed at the end of last session.
Okay.
I told you this, but we just kind of wrapped up last time. You didn't
act. So we're close to Haven. I didn't know that. Okay.
You're a few days travel. It's, and you would have to have like some kind of airship to get over the mountains. But if you wanted to go to Haven, you could from here. And as you're approaching the town, you see a crow that you'd seen multiple times fly towards the town and just kind of disappear into the small town.
Right, and it looked like any other crow, so we didn't pay attention to it.
I think one of you did pay attention to it. I forget which one of you, and you'd seen it multiple times during this whole day, but it didn't look anything more than just a crow, according to your perception checks. And this town, just so you have a little more information, is much larger than the village you had visited earlier. This is not like a full city, like Argus or... it's not like Argus or anything. It's not enormous, but it does have multi-story buildings. It does have some amount of trade, and there are airships coming in and out of the town. And it looks like it's at least somewhat defended. It has its back, part of the town is protected in the back by these like mountains behind it, and it looks like it's using that as natural fortification. And the front is blocked by this large wall, and on top of the wall you see guards walking back and forth. There's nothing mechanical defending the town, but there are a number of people who may or may not be hunters or huntresses guarding this town. So it looks like this is not... It just looks much more well-defended. This is a much more well-defended town than the one you'd already visited. And with that said, I'm just going to hand it off to you as you guys approach the gates of this town, of Green Grove. And what would you guys like to do?
Are we talking to the people?
You can take some time to talk to the musicians if you'd like to before we get to the town. You didn't really get a chance last session, so we can do that first if you'd like.
By the way, sirs, what gig are you planning to do at this town anyway?
Are you speaking with Dandelion?
Sure.
We kind of just go where the wind takes us. But we've been to Green Grove a couple times. I think we're gonna go to... There's a nice little bar we've been to a few times. It's the what was the name of it? It was so entrancing. I think it was the Stumble Inn. It was a very nice place.
Stumble, eh?
Sounds glamorous.
What's this town like?
Oh, it's rather boring. Rather boring.
Boring.
It's not very cultured. There's people living their lives safe behind some walls. No one interesting, but they enjoy music and they have money, so we're on our way.
I mean, how boring can it be? Their defenses are so high.
Oh, the most boring people stay in the most offended towns. The places like Ramshorn, so much more interesting. We met a old man there a few times. He was such a character.
Yeah, quite the character.
I don't remember you being so snooty, Dandelion.
Oh, I just... This is who I am.
I guess. Okay.
I have a question for the DM.
Yes.
For those of us who went to Haven Academy, would we know anything about this area?
You can make a check to see if you remember anything, but you may know something, yes.
What kind of check?
Let's see. I'd say for this, it would be a let's say a sharps check. Like, you're going to be trying to rack your memory, see if you remember something.
Okay. I'm going to make one.
Okay. I'll do one, too.
Are you also from this area?
Yeah, we both went to Haven.
Right.
Hold on.
Okay, let's see.
All right, I rolled a 9. I don't think that's good enough.
Let's see what Opal's roll is first.
19.
That is good.
good memory.
So, Harm, you try to think back, and you know that there are towns along the mountain ridge here in the foothills, but you don't remember this one. You don't remember anything really helpful about the general towns here. You just know there are a number of towns along the foothills of the mountains, which isn't really helpful for what you're trying to remember.
Oh,
but
shucks.
But Opal, mm-hmm. you remember that this town is one of the not the biggest trading city, because I mean, like, there's still Argus and other big towns cities around in Mistral, but Greengrove is one of the largest landlocked trading centers of the region. This place sees a lot of people go in and out, and has been kind of the unofficial capital of Mistral for a long time, because Haven is the center of Mistral, but a lot of the government, a lot of the place where the non-huntsmen and huntresses, like, decide laws or help send out aid to places, this is where it's decided. So there's a place of government here that's kind of unofficial, but a lot of people listen to them when they say things. Like, if they say they want to send help to Ramshorn, a lot of other towns and villages will follow suit. So it's more like this. There's a lot of, I forget the word, there's political power here.
They're influencers.
So it is a boring town.
Clout?
Yeah, clout. That's probably the right word for it, Dylan. So there's no real official power here, but when they do stuff, a lot of people follow.
They have all the money.
Yeah.
A question for the DM. Yeah. Did you mention if the band is Faunus or not?
Yes, I answered this last session, but no, none of them appear to be Faunuses. Okay. But that said, remember that Mist is completely covered, so you don't know what they look like under those clothes. And they have kept those clothes. They have kept those clothes on even as they sleep, even if they do sleep, which you're not sure of.
Okay.
Any other questions for me, the DM, or you want to continue talking to the music?
DM, is it summer? Is it winter? Is it fall?
The days are getting longer. It's not winter yet.
It's spring.
But shorter. The days are getting shorter. Okay, it's not winter yet. It's cool. There's a chill in the air. The wind blows by, and there's kind of a shiver sometimes, but it's not quite freezing or anything like that. There's no snow. But when it rains, it really is miserable. But it's not hot or anything like that.
Talk to Mist.
Yeah, sure. Go ahead.
Yes. Okay. Yeah. Hey, Mist. So we've been walking along for a while here, I guess. But what's your deal? Why are you all covered up?
In a voice that is kind of a little bit higher, but you can't tell if it's a high male voice or kind of a deeper woman's voice. They respond, "I'm just trying to survive, you know."
Ophelia. Yeah, my problem, why I have to wear my clothes, is because, like, people go blind, so that's kind of inconvenient sometimes.
Does seem inconvenient.
Yeah, it kind of sucks. Yeah.
How do you deal with the heat? Because it sometimes gets tough for me in this thing.
Yeah, it kind of sucks. It's better now because, you know, like, the wind's blowing and the cool breeze and everything. That's good. Winter's definitely better.
What small talk?
Harm's gonna put her hand on Kane's shoulder and be like, "See that? That's bonding. That's how you gotta do it."
And Kane is just gonna brush past her and just walk ahead of everybody.
Okay. Oh, Kane, bye. Okay.
You didn't know this happened. You were talking to him. You weren't really with them. Sorry.
Cool, I think she saw you walk past very quickly.
No, but not through them. I just walked around them.
Kane's just leading the group. That's all Kane's doing.
No, I'm going to say to Miss, like, I think she has a thing for you.
Oh, my God.
She's got a history. It's sometimes awkward, but, like, she's got a history of just everyone. No one's safe from Kane.
Oh, my God.
With Mr. Spud, you kind of hear a little bit of a smile in their voice. Well, I hate to disappoint them, but I have someone waiting for me.
Oh, where?
You didn't disappoint me. Where are you from?
Okay, Kate. Where? I went to Haven myself. Where are you from, the area?
The smile kind of, you kind of miss the mirth in their voice in the next part. Sorry, I can't really talk about any of that.
Okay. Cool. Cool.
Well,
do I prefer that? I don't know.
This is the part where we cut to entering the town.
I think so. Yeah. Cool.
Does anyone else want to talk to the other
members? Well, I wanted to ask anybody what kind of music they play.
Yeah. What do they play?
Well, we haven't heard from Flora at all yet.
Okay, I'm going to go up to her. So, what kind of... Do you like jazz?
Oh, jazz is so fun. Flute, people don't give flute enough credit. You can really play some good jazz on a flute. But,
right?
But yeah, when we're in towns, it just depends on the mood. You know, if you're at a funeral, it's kind of hard to play a jaunty tune. But we did that once. Didn't really go over well.
I mean, maybe you'd have better luck if it was an asshole's funeral.
That's a good idea. We should put up like flyers, see if anybody really shitty died. Yeah, that'd be fun.
I would definitely pay some good money to go to that kind of funeral.
Yeah.
This is the kind of town for it, too.
Oh, good call. I wonder if a politician died recently.
Actually, oh, no, wait, we didn't kill him. Never mind.
But yeah, we're all really self-taught, so I'm not really that great at a lot of the different music types, but I don't know. I really like the really light, bouncy music. Where like you can just kind of feel the energy moving through the crowd and the band back and forth. It's just so energetic. I just feel so empowered by it.
Feel you, I think. I mean, I don't play an instrument, but I do like music.
Do you guys have a semblance? Because maybe that's your semblance.
Floor
being
turns,
blunt.
Yeah, Floor turns to you and smiles and like, that would be telling.
Oh, uh-oh.
Telling? What? Of what?
It's all part of the show. I can't tell you the secret.
Oh, I see. Okay.
Does this mean if... Wait, hold on. If we guess, can we get in for free?
I think we've at least earned getting in for free.
That's true.
Dear, you can come to our show. Don't worry. You help protect us on the way there. We'll give you a show for free.
Sweet. Thank you.
But I know for a fact you will not be able to guess it.
We'll see about that. I'm definitely not going to be able to guess it.
What do you call it? That may be a hint.
Oh, yeah. Do you have a name for it?
I do. I'm not going to tell you it.
Can you give us a hint?
No.
A little tiny hint?
She rolls her eyes and just kind of just focuses on the road and kind of ignores it to try to needle her for its secrets.
Hey, guys. We're here. We're here.
And, conveniently, Moon is correct. You arrive at Green Grove's big gate. It's like one of those big castle type gates with like the two doors that are really big that go swing in and out. And in front of it, you see what appears to be a guard, but less a guard, more just what appears to be someone who's checking people who are coming into town and checking to see what you're there for. Maybe just like just getting a feel for who's entering the town. And above the wall, above the gate, there are a number of people with guns and bow and arrows chatting kind of amicably. They don't seem concerned about anyone really breaking in right now. This seems to be just for show, just to be like a show of force that there's protection here and don't try anything stupid in front of them. And the guard waves you down and says, this way, yada, gotta come to me first before you get into the town.
Hi, guard. Hi, what's your name?
Hi, guard. Moon,
you cannot be our representative here.
Oh, I'm in front, don't worry. You guys were talking, I was running in front.
True. I thought Kane was in front.
Yeah, Kane ran ahead.
Oh, Kane did run ahead, yeah. Me and Kane, okay.
Yeah. Answering Moon's question, it looks like this man is a little older. They actually have graying hair. They're still fairly attractive, Yeah, they're still fairly attractive, but they're a little older than the hot 20-year-old you're used to seeing around here. And they're starting the shrinkage toward old age, as all people.
I don't think that's how that works. Okay.
Well, Maria did it.
Yeah, it's a trend.
Okay, in the show. Okay, I see. Yeah. But our evidence is one old person. Yeah.
Yeah, okay. Dylan, we've seen one old person. This is how it has to. But my name's Gray. I'm the captain of the guard here. I just
Gray
town. Yeah.
Oh, hi. You created Genlock. Just kidding. Okay. Yeah. Hi.
Oh my God.
Did you name yourself after your hair?
Ouch.
It's a family name, Moon.
What he means is what do you need from us?
That's not what I meant.
Oh, but we're just moving on.
I put my hand on Moon's mouth as this happens.
Pull him away.
Sorry. I'm so sorry. Guys, we didn't say the team name. What was your team name when we started?
Team
Mocha?
Yeah, there you go. That's important information we should have started with at the beginning.
We're Final. Team Mocha.
Are you telling this to the guard? Or
yeah.
Should we go by team?
No, I have my hand over your mouth. You are not speaking anymore.
Azure, roll a dexterity check to see if you can cover Moon's mouth.
Wrangle Moon.
Stop him. Wrangle
Moon.
20.
Wait, did you get a 20, Alex? Yeah,
17 plus 3.
Oh, damn.
I'm just going to say you got Dylan. Dylan can no longer talk during this encounter. Dylan has to make a strength check to get out of this.
What?
I don't know if this is more annoying or not.
I'm not joining.
What?
I'm not joking.
Moon can't be stopped.
So he does a flip and gets out.
Yeah. Okay. Oh yeah. We're Team Mocha. Like I said. Hi. Oh yeah. This is who everyone is, and we're very excited to come into town. What's in here? What's up with this place?
Gray kind of like puts his hand on his head and starts rubbing his forehead, and he just kind of goes, "Oh God, another one." What is your business here in Green Grove?
Yeah, another one. Could Sun have been by?
Oh wow, maybe we are following Sun. Wow.
Can you please answer the question? What are you here?
That's a good question.
We're with these musicians. We're just tagging along.
That's not a good answer.
We just came from a village, a couple ways off, and
if it helped, it was west of where you are now.
They were having some grim trouble, and now we helped them out, and now we're just making our way through.
Oh, that's concerning. Which town was it? Are they? How much damage did they take?
It was pretty bad.
It's obliterated.
You should probably send some people over there.
You know what? I think that's a really good idea. You should.
Which town was
it? It's a little.
Didn't catch the name.
Did any of us remember?
Oh my God! Actually, how about all of you make sharps check to see if you can remember what happened 2 days ago?
This is not fair.
Come on, that's not fair.
I
want to
say Ravensbrook.
Not 20.
Out of 10.
You got the first letter right.
Okay, that's good enough. Let's hear.
Wait, I'm not 20. Do I remember?
Okay.
It doesn't matter.
The information springs into your head, and you just like feel the need to shout it out when you remember. And the name of the town is Ramshorn.
It was Ramshorn.
The guard like shakes his head like, "Whoa, you need to shout. I'm right here."
Sorry, it happens sometimes.
So it was the town of Ramshorn that got attacked.
Yeah,
I mean, look at my horns, man. Do I look like I not know something about rams? I'm just gonna walk away.
Appreciative that you just kind of turn around because he seems not happy with you. And it's unclear to you whether it's because you shouted or because he now notices that you're a faunus.
Oh,
that was a bad move.
He just now noticed.
So, well, I mean, but to be clear, like, Moon, the very clear faunus, was taking up a lot of his attention at the beginning.
Yeah, that's my job.
But he does seem concerned about what you're telling him, and I'll skip you guys telling him any pertinent information that you want that he asks for, because that would take a while, some kind of interviewing process. But he does take this information and kind of puts his hand on his chin and says, "That's not good. That's the third town this month that's been completely burned down."
Third?
Yeah.
What other towns?
It's been a town to the north. It was went by the name of Mahogany. That was a town in the middle of another...
Mahogany? Okay.
Yeah.
That is Mahogany.
It is, yeah. I think we need to talk to whoever's in charge here, because someone was buying those attacks, and that would be good information.
It follows, and it... All three of the towns fit the same kind of profile. They're all small towns, no more than a couple hundred people, easily burnable materials, no more than wooden walls.
Easily burnable.
I mean, mahogany.
Yeah. Did you hear anything about there's no, like, stone structures outside of the town protecting it? They could just kind of burn their way through everything, and that's just fits with their MO.
Were there any reports about
here? Like, spread them around a bit.
Wait, were there reports about Grimm showing up after the fires?
This is the first one we actually caught where anyone survived. The other two, everyone died before we got anyone there.
We should go talk to some people inside.
Yeah, is there anyone you can direct us to?
That would be a good idea. I can give you a couple guards to lead you the way. I think it's important that you come in. Do you vouch for the other, are these three travelers with you? The other three that are in the back?
Oh, we don't know them. Just kidding. Just kidding.
we help them get here, but I don't know if I'll go as so far they're as just I vouch for them.
Three other travelers coming
to
with
get
you.
Dane Ladier, come on.
I would vouch for them, is what I'm telling you.
Then we will interview them separately, if you're fine separating yourself from them for now.
Yep. All right, let's go
They can handle themselves.
Yeah, they'll be fine.
And, Dandy waves to you, says, like, don't worry about us. This is normal.
Bye, weirdos. Bye.
If you head to the Stumble Inn, we'll be there playing. You're all getting free.
Hell yeah.
That's nice. Okay, we'll maybe be there, unless something more interesting happens. Okay, bye.
Give me an autograph.
Mist and Floor also give friendly little waves as you leave.
Yep.
Bye.
As you're let into the town, you see two guards with kind of shoddily made spears and armor covering their entire body. Standing at attention, waiting for you. The one on the left, a woman, speaks out and says, follow me, we are going to the Parliament building.
Hi, who are you?
My name is Arl. I am the...
How do you spell that?
A-R-Y-L.
Oh, that's cool. I like that.
I am the first lieutenant of the wall, and I will lead you to someone who can help.
I like how readily you answered my question on the spelling of your name. You're cool.
Question to DM.
Yes.
Can you tell me what the rank? I know that Kane should know this, but Beatrice doesn't know this. Where does first lieutenant fall in terms of ranking of like officers and stuff?
Oh my God, let me pull up a hierarchy for you. I don't have the exact one ready offhand.
All right. Well, I was going to enter the specialist as an officer. All right, fine. Well, I just got out of Atlas.
Okay. I'm gonna be exceedingly nice here. Roll luck, and I will tell you what your rank was, where you ended it.
All right, question. Luck is also okay. Fine. Right.
Luck is just a straight stat. And also, tell me, are you in the Navy, the Air Force, or the Army?
I don't want to do it anymore.
You have to decide.
If you get a 20, you could be running the whole.
No, I didn't get a 20. I don't want to do this anymore.
What'd you get?
I don't want to do. Why can't I just be an officer?
Your whole backstory is being in the Army.
Get that what?
I got a 5. Yay! Hold on, I need to add.
That's not like, terrible.
Kane talks a big game.
I think this checked out with Kane.
Look, all I did was ask if the first lieutenant, what the rank is of the first lieutenant. I didn't say anything about me. I didn't say any, like, talk big game.
You are a second lieutenant, Kane. Or were.
Rip.
So, just so you know, Kane, the first officer, like, the first officer rank, the lowest officer rank, is an officer cadet. And the one right above that is a second lieutenant. So you did have some
power.
Power over the younger officers, but that's about it. Like,
which
everyone
makes sense because I was discriminated against. It fits the story.
Yeah.
Okay, good.
The rank above second lieutenant is first lieutenant. So this person in front of you is the equivalent of the rank above you. But again, these are different armies. It doesn't really transfer at all. Like, this is a different thing altogether.
Okay.
Okay. The point is, this woman, Arl, is going to lead you to the Parliament building to talk with someone.
A-R-Y-L. Hi, yeah. Arl, how long you been in this town?
I've been here my whole life, actually. I grew up here, I trained here, and I just want to defend it. I really
I'm
want
to... I'm so sorry.
That's not a nice
strength.
Is that bad?
Don't say that.
It's a boring life.
Seems very boring.
Wow.
I like it. I've fought off a number of Grimm attacks. I've protected my family and others' families, and it's fulfilling for me. I can understand how you huntsmen and huntresses like to travel between town and town, but there's something, I don't know, really nice about knowing that I have a home and it's not going to go anywhere.
Wait, since you've been here your whole life, what type of stuff should we do while we're here? What's the cool stuff?
I'd really, it gets a little unsafe near the evening, but we have this fun little, wow, I can't think of the word for it. Like, what are those things that are like ski lifts, those things that go up mountains?
A chairlift.
Chairlift. Or not chairlift, but they have like a whole car.
A gondola?
I guess a gondola?
Oh, a sky car?
Yeah, like a sky.
A big one that's like an actual like car, like a cart thing. It's not like a chair, but it's like a thing you go inside and the doors close.
Like a train car type size thing.
Oh, a trolley?
No, anyway. Like in the air.
This is Ruby, so it would have a dumb name like an air trolley.
Yeah, air trolley. Yeah. We're calling it an air trolley because Alex is 100% right that it would have a dumb name. We have like an air trolley that goes up to the highest mountain around here. Have you ever been there?
No, we just got to town.
We call it the Chungin Mountain. It's you can see like from
my Say that fast.
Yeah, what was that name?
Chungi Mountain?
Chungin Mountains.
Ooh, what a beautiful name.
Wow. I've never heard such beautiful words spoken, yeah.
So Arl, have you been hearing about the attacks in the other towns? Does that make you nervous?
Her eyes fall and she Yes, it's rather concerning. We get attacked, but this is much more often than usual.
What do you get attacked by?
We don't. That's the part of the issue. We don't know. We just know that there are people doing it. There's a lot of whispers that it's the White Fang, and that's not good. They haven't been this violent before.
So it's
It was the White Fang.
Mm-hmm.
The guess is that it's the White Fang.
Oh, no, but we know.
We know it's the White Fang.
Yes. Sorry. They don't. These people don't know.
I know. I'm telling her. Inappropriately telling her.
How do you know?
Don't worry about it. We'll talk to the who are you taking?
Why don't we go to Parliament and talk to them first?
I feel like we're getting arrested, guys. Like this is like a trap.
I agree.
Cannot say yes or no there.
Okay, you know what? Maybe we should just we're inside. Let's just go our own way.
Yeah, be like, why that looks cool over there. Why don't we meet you back at the Parliament in a bit? Yeah, we're gonna go get our friends.
I trust these weirdos. I trust them.
Arl,
you trust the government, but not the hippies.
No.
Yeah, man.
I didn't. The hippies were just boring. this was getting caught. Getting tricked would be exciting. So let's do that.
Oh my god.
All right, team leader, let's go.
Oh yeah, right. I'm the M.
Wait, no. Are you the team leader?
Yeah, oh, he's my god, the M.
I'm the M.
Oh yeah.
So we're going. Let's talk.
True.
All right. Side note, because Kane respects rank, she always is just very like, she always follows Moon, whatever he decides to do, even if she thinks it's a bad idea.
Oh boy.
I'm telling you, hates I'm like
Kane for this because they're like, we value your opinion, and why are you doing this?
Hey, hey guys. So you guys are going to follow Arl where she goes?
Yeah, I'm suspicious about it, but I'm going to do it.
Apparently, yeah.
Let's go, Arl. Let's go, Aryl. Let's go.
Is she hot?
Are you obviously.
Every time?
No, just with her, because she's a military lady.
Okay.
By default, everyone's hot in Ruby.
True.
Yes, but there's different types of hot. This is soldier hot.
Yeah, is she an older, like...
Elaborate on that.
Does she have a family? Like, does she have kids?
She's the type of person that Beatrice...
You mentioned a family. That
oh, she does I have a would... family?
Yeah.
All right.
Think like Brie Larson, like super muscle.
That's exactly who I was picturing.
All right.
Why?
But what? Maybe
because
she might
military.
Have... She so might harm's have a Maria at now. Home. I have to ask, you know?
A what at home?
A Maria. Have you not seen Captain Marvel? You should watch Captain Marvel.
Oh my god. Maria is someone else in the show.
Yeah, that's what I thought you were talking about.
We were talking about Brie Larson. That was stop, a very small stop, jump to Captain Marvel.
Stop. We're keeping on track here.
Okay, let's follow her.
She asked Arl.
Yes. Yeah.
Do you have a family? Do you have like a wife, kids, husband? Oh, I don't know. I don't want to assume.
Both. Neither.
I haven't really. There's somebody I'm thinking of, but there's not a lot of time when you're in the army.
Who's that? Who's that somebody? Tell us.
Tell us your life story.
Yeah.
I'm good.
Okay, well, we'll just go then. We'll just go.
Are we at the parliament yet?
I feel like Moon gets that a lot. But okay,
yeah, I think he would get that a lot, Dylan. And as you go through town, you walk past a bunch of buildings, you pass a market, you pass a bunch of civilians running around. They seem to be happy and in good spirits. Your scrolls, which you all have phones, which I always forget is a thing in Ruby. You all have phones. Yeah. You have good service here, so you can contact.
Yeah, the communications network is not down yet. We can
Because suddenly Kane's phone starts to blow up because her grandfather has been texting her and she hasn't been responding because there was no service.
This is how D&D works.
It is her phone. I'm interested.
Wait, it's my phone. Can my phone not blow up?
No. You just have to tell me outside the session and I will tell you it's blowing up.
Yeah, how was I going to know? Question about how D&D works. How was I supposed to know that we were going to go into this town that had service and know that
we didn't really know about
that
our phones,
I could tell you, by the way, when we get here, my phone's going to blow. That makes no sense.
The way you bring it up in a session, Beatrice, is to say, hey, can I include this in my backstory that people text me a lot? And I say, sure. You know,
I'll make sure to include it in the backstory.
Beatrice, you can tell me like now that that's something you want to do because I'm fine.
Well, that was me telling you.
Telling the audience.
No. You don't tell the audience my phone blows up. You tell me, hey, can my phone blow up? And I'll be like,
okay,
sure.
Hey, can my phone blow up?
Sure, Beatrice.
Thanks. Wow, D&D, bro. Okay.
Just remember, you're not God.
You are not God. As long as it's a small thing, like.
It's my phone. It's like not a big deal. He just wants to know that I'm alive.
But like in real life, can you just say, hey, people are going to begin texting me?
I know, like, you know. I was trying to make it as smooth as possible.
Well, no, but you tell me that your phone, you generally get a lot of texts and I'll accept that. And you get service and you have two texts from your grandfather and nothing else.
Wow. It's strange to me because I usually get a lot of texts.
Sure.
From what type of person?
From a person who rhymes with Shmironwood.
That's why is Ironwood texting you? No.
Did you not read my backstory?
Wait, Ironwood is your grandpa?
Backstory is pretty long. I might not have gotten through. I'm not sure.
He's my mentor. He literally scouted me to go to Atlas. Mm. You guys. He was the one who told me.
Look,
as long as it's not girls,
I agree with.
No, it's part of my backstory. Ironwood always is like keeping me up to date or telling me to do things. Sometimes that was established way in the beginning.
You should ask Ironwood about this town. See if he has any warnings against this place.
Andy, can I ask Ironwood about this town? Even though I haven't gotten a message from him,
you can attempt to text him.
Since that's a you action, you can do that. Yeah.
Okay, great. So what we're gonna do is. I'm going to text two people. I'm going to text Ironwood and give him an update. I'm not expecting a reply, even though maybe in the text message I'll be like, haven't heard from you, but this is what we're doing.
Wow.
Because I'm like, he's probably busy. Like, I understand that. But I'm just sending him an update of hey, there are some towns that are like being attacked near Mistral. There are some towns that are being attacked. Just thought you should know. Something weird's going on. And I'm also going to text my grandpa telling him I'm alive. I'm like, hey, make sure you eat drink your vitamins.
You eat your vegetables.
Two texts from grandpa are, the first one is just checking in to see that you're safe. I haven't heard from you in a little bit. And the second one reads, have you found a good woman yet?
Okay. All right. So I'm going to
Supportive grandpa. Nice.
All right. So grandpa is, I'm going to respond to grandpa like, ignoring the first message, the second message, I'm okay, thanks, I'm okay, hope everything's good with you. That's the grandpa message. Do I have to roll something?
No.
Question for the DM, what's the emoji situation in Ruby?
I will allow...
Peri dabs.
I feel like they do emojis.
Pretty flexible. If you tell me an emoji exists, I will pretty much be okay with that.
Poop emoji.
Never more emoji.
You can have a never more emoji.
All right, so to Ironwood, Kane sends the message, whatever, and then she gives him a grim thumbs up. Sends over a grim thumbs up.
Grim thumbs up. Grim are bad, though. I don't know if they would ever thought
of it. I'm offended by that statement.
I'm pretty sure that they have, like, the cartoon, cutesy Grim emojis. I'm pretty sure they would have that.
No, I'm actually going to say that there is a Grim thumbs down and, like, a human thumbs up. And that's
yeah, that would be...
Oh, wow.
Also, it'd be, like, Faunus thumbs down, human thumbs up.
All right, well, then I won't say a thumbs down because I wanted it to be funny and ironic and be a Grim thumbs up. Okay, never mind. Well, anyway, those are the two texts I sent.
Okay. Anyways, if no one else wants to text for like,
I would just like to interject that my contacts list is empty because I have no close human relations.
Yeah, you don't have a phone.
Do you even have a phone?
No, yeah, he does. We got him a phone. We got him a scroll.
I have a phone, but it has all default.
If you guys
apps.
Don't want a phone, that's fine. I'm just saying you can default have a phone.
No, we should have phones so we can communicate with each other. But definitely Azure and I don't have any contacts.
Yeah, no, and that's fine.
Well, you probably
have the other people in Mocha in your contact.
Yeah, but they're it.
Did we exchange numbers? Are we that close yet?
We're a team.
I feel like we already moved past like introductions. No, we're good. We got it.
Okay.
Anyways,
I'm gonna spend the rest of the campaign texting. Is that okay?
Yeah, sure. As long as you don't talk, it's fine.
Wow. That's what I'll be doing in the background. Okay.
Are you texting like all your quote unquote friends?
Yeah, from Menagerie.
Moon would be like really popular, I think.
I have a lot of orphan friends from Menagerie.
Yeah. Are you texting Sun as well?
I don't know Sun yet.
Whom's? Anyways, you continue to follow Errol, who is very confused. Like, it's just like turns around to see if you want to talk anymore, and sees that all of you are just like tip tapping away on your phones, just and
nattering
like,
at each other.
And she's
I'm staring intently at her because I don't know what else to do in this situation.
Also, I'm just gonna pretend that everyone's okay with your Grim, Alex, because it's really stupid and they don't want to deal with it.
Can he just be invisible until he like comes out to fuck shit up?
I mean, we can add that. Can we add that ability to make?
I'll be nice and say he can transform a little bit to be like look like a normal wolf.
Yes.
Okay.
Oh my god, we have a wolf. Yes.
Yeah, so he's changed color to be brownish, so...
And I'll say that this is part of your semblance's ability. Like, it allows the Grim to be less Grimmish when you tame them.
Okay.
But, again, your semblance is a lot more... Not a lot less combat-focused. Like, you do it in the middle of combat. You have to capture a Grim, which is not easy most of the time. Anyways, moving on. Errol leads you to the Parliament Building, and... which is a not large structure. When I say Parliament Building, it doesn't look like you can have a parliament larger than 50 people. Like, this is not the hundreds large, like, House of Congress that we have in the U.S. This is more just, like, the most that you can get out of, like, a few towns. And as she leads you through, it doesn't look like anything's in session right now, but she leads you to what appears to be a senior member of the Parliament's office, and on the door you see the name of Byzantium, with no last name.
As it's spelled.
Byzantium.
We would actually know because there's a name on the door. Yeah. Okay. Yes.
Arl knocks on the door lightly with the back of her knuckle, and you hear a male voice from the inside yell out, "Come in! I'm just open the door. I can't get there right now." Errol opens the door and you don't see anyone inside. You see a desk, some bookcases, and you hear a bang from underneath the desk, and someone saying, "Oh, crap!" And you see a short man step out from behind the desk, and get off his knees as he says, "Damn it, I lost my contact."
Oh, hi, are you Byzantium? Are you all right?
Biz is fine.
Biz.
Biz.
Biz. Yes.
Yeah. Hi, Biz.
You only have one contact? Does he have an eye patch or something?
No, I lost
one of the two contacts.
Yeah, that happens.
Rip.
We'll help you find it.
No. It's not. No, we will Moon, not. Stop.
Take where you are.
No, you don't.
No. Moon, do you move towards him?
No, I offered. I didn't do anything yet.
Okay. Don't move. I don't know where the contact is, and it could be around there.
Can we look for it? Like, visually?
Can I have a sharp check?
You can look without moving your feet.
Okay.
May I ask if Russ is capable of sniffing out the contact?
I
don't know. Contacts.
What is the storyline?
They smell like an eyeball.
Opal, sorry, what were you asking?
What is this storyline? I'm just going to stand there. Just let this play out. I still feel like we're in a trap.
Dude, are you actually helping?
We want to look. We're looking.
I offer.
Well, we apparently, if it's we coming from Moon, that means Kane also is involved.
Okay. Yeah. All right.
I got a 14 total on the sharp check.
I got a 10.
Anyone else rolling?
I'll roll. Like, can I roll for Russ?
Yeah, roll for Russ.
Russ would not help here.
Okay, fine. Then I'm staying out.
I'm staying out of this.
Okay. Moon, you do not spot the contact, unfortunately, and you see Biz kind of crawling around on the floor again, looking around with. He has this kind of purplish hair, and you see his outfit is kind of in line with the rest of his color scheme of kind of this deep purple color. And he's just looking around and he just looks really frustrated about this. And he eventually gets up and he's like, damn it. I guess I'll just have to get a new one tonight. I'll just have to deal with it. Sorry. He puts out a hand for you first, Moon, because you are standing in the front, I assume. And
Hi, I'm Moon. We're Team Mocha.
Good to meet you.
We can find your contact, but you shouldn't have to get a whole new contact. That seems like a lot of trouble to go through.
Well, we can deal with that. I can deal with that later. Don't worry about that. Arl, thank you for bringing them to me. Are these the people that Gray mentioned? And Arl responds with, yes, sir. These are the ones that came from Ramshorn. Thank you very much.
That was quick.
Technology.
I mean, it's texting.
You big texter?
I'm gonna move past that. So you five came from Ramshorn, I heard.
Guy's not receptive to my nonsense. Okay.
We did.
And you said that it had been burned down?
It was.
Are we sitting? Can we sit?
I only have two chairs.
Can we go to a conference room or something?
How about we just shut the door? We can... We can just stay here.
Can I levitate on an air ball? Do I have to make a check for that?
Why are you A-ing?
Because.
Okay.
Not creative.
You would have to spend a fair number of aura.
All right, fuck that. Never mind.
Remember, aura is a resource.
Are we cursing in this podcast? I don't remember.
Yeah, we can. Yes. I didn't say it at the beginning of this podcast, but we definitely can curse. We cursed a lot last time.
Okay. I didn't remember that.
Oh, we... Dylan, we all...
Moon doesn't curse, it's fine.
Yeah. You don't remember because you were, like, drunk. I don't know.
There's a lot to remember from last time. None of us remembered the town name.
None of you did, which was insane. Anyway,
how was that insane?
I'm going to move on again. Anyways, Biz just kind of, like, motions. You kind of make a loose circle around him as he leans back on his desk with his like butt kind of leaning on it, so he's lazily sitting. Anyone, if you guys want to sit, you can, but I mean, this, we just need to work this out quickly. So you guys went to Ramshorn. Did you see who did it?
No.
I want to get to know you better before we talk about this.
Can I try putting my hand on his mouth?
I'm uncomfortable with how direct you're being, and
Why are you uncomfortable with this?
Why
haven't you offered us refreshments or anything yet?
I am the highest ranking member of the, let's say, the liberal party here in Green.
Let's say. I don't like that.
Liberal.
Yeah, you're not sounding very trustworthy.
Yeah, no.
Like, let's say we don't trust you. Like,
the name doesn't matter. I'm in the liberal party in this region.
Define liberal.
Yeah.
Oh my god.
Because your guards were kind of...
Okay, why did your guards bring us to you? That's my big question.
Because Parliament is not in session right now. Only the high-ranking members stay here during times when they're not in session. So I'm here. There are two other Parliament members here as well. but they are not in the majority. They do not have majority control right now. And
Biz, where are you from?
I am from Green Grove. I live here. I grew up here, and I intend to die here.
Damn, those musicians really were kidding.
Yeah.
All right. Well.
Anyways,
do you want to tell him?
No.
Damn
not
it!
Feeling, not put the head on this one.
Were you lying? Did you not? Did you go to Ramshorn?
We're not lying. I just haven't told you everything yet because you're not being very trustworthy.
Oh my god! Do you want me to read you a bedtime story?
Yes, please do.
Yeah, boy.
Is he always like this as a biz?
All the time.
I nod feverishly.
Yeah.
Can any of you speak with me instead of him?
No, I'm the leader. You can speak. You can speak to all of us.
Can I roll to cover his mouth again?
I am protecting us. So come on. This is a good decision.
All right. So you're going to try to cover his mouth?
Yeah.
Kane should defend me here.
Dylan, you can attempt to stop this with a opposing roll of your own.
Okay, well, I rolled a 17 plus 3. That's another 20.
I did not roll that. Kane can roll too, I think.
Kane, are you going to stop?
I mean, I have listened to him when he, like, do I have to? I can't stop Azure from doing things.
Well, no. Do you want to try to stop Azure?
I think Azure is, I am acting in the best interest of the team here. I think Azure is acting.
No, I covered your mouth. You're not talking.
That didn't happen yet. So that didn't go through yet.
No.
Okay. Dylan, you now have to make a strength check if you ever want to talk, but we get a few minutes without Moon talking first. I'll let you know you can strength check to get him off you, okay?
Okay. Not talking for a few minutes. I don't know if that's possible.
Does anyone else want to tell me what happened?
What do you know?
This is the third of three towns that have been destroyed in this month. We need to figure out who is doing this, why they're doing it, so we can stop them.
Well, did you have any clues from the other two towns that were burned?
All we know is they were burned to a crisp, and it looked like it was done by some type of humanoids. Not Grimm, not any sufficiently advanced technology, just burning down towns with torches, Molotovs, things of that nature. But we did not find any evidence of what group of bandits, whether they were from a different country, whether they're the White Fang. We did not find anything of that nature.
All right, so before I tell you what happened, can you just explain something to me? How much influence does this town have? Like, do you have people that report to you from other, that are like in other towns? Like, what is, like, how familiar are you with the business of other towns? Because if you're the mecca of everything, then you should have known that the White Fang were the ones who attacked that town because the head of that town was killing Faunus.
Why would I? Oh my god.
Okay, can we? Can I break out? Can I break out?
You can make a roll, Dylan. This seems like a moment where you would
want
to break out.
I don't want this happening. What am I rolling?
Strike.
It's important that I break out of this, let me just say. I got a 12.
Alex, you have to make a strength roll as well. Sorry.
Okay. This is not good.
Not 20.
Can someone help me? I have interesting plot things to say.
Azure, you want to let Moon out at this point?
Nope.
Oh, why?
Azure is not a troll like Alex is. I feel like this is.
No, it's not. It's not being a troll. It's more being annoyed with you taking the conversation in different places, and I want us to reveal the facts, which is something in my character. Mm-hmm. I just want to get.
I'm telling you, I have interesting directions like this, but okay.
Alex, I just want to say this is probably the most one of your characters has ever done in a campaign.
Yes.
Right here.
You're really influencing things because I would not have let this happen.
You're influencing things a lot more than you could even imagine, right?
Okay, I have like pushed my hand further into his face and I say to Kane, yeah, keep talking.
I like gesture at Kane and Opal, like, please. Like
Okay.
Well, anything?
Can I
anything?
Be like looking around seeing if we're about to get jumped?
Can I just say Faunuses should want to help me here, please? This is I give that hand. That
wow. hand. You're making this a racist thing? How dare you?
Opal isn't even a Faunus.
No.
Do you care about what's happening here, or are you just going along with it?
Okay, Kane is Dan.
Allie, Harm.
What?
Are you doing anything about this? Are you just listening right now? Like, I'm not telling you to do anything. I'm just making sure you're just fine listening to this scene play out.
I'm kind of not, but I also don't know what I could do to fix it. And I
join just me push in him
away. He's tiny. He's a kid. Push him away.
Well, I mean, she doesn't need you, Dylan. If Harm wants to say something, she can do it herself.
Well, Harm could also shush Beaches right now from revealing things. Yeah. Right.
I think I'm gonna just put a hand on her shoulder and give her a look.
Like, I thought you were gonna say over her mouth. Shut up, like.
No, not over her mouth, on her shoulder.
Have
and
fangs.
Just give her a telling look,
reminding
like.
Reminding everybody.
Like, honey, we're Faunus. Don't go too far.
Right,
because I was very upset because the Faunus thing.
I'm just gonna give her a look because she knows I was part of the White Fang before.
Right, okay.
Ooh, that.
So, and Kane calms down.
Well, unfortunately, Biz does not look happy. He looks like you can see a vein throbbing in his forehead. Did you just accuse me of killing my own constituents?
No, I accused you of ignorance. Of voluntary ignorance.
You accused me of turning a blind eye to someone who is killing people regularly, essentially.
I don't know you, so yes.
Well, okay, as a DM, what the fuck, Beatrice?
I'm just saying, if this is like the most influential town and all the other towns listen to this town, I don't think it would be big to assume that this town has people in other towns like representing them. And it also wouldn't be big to assume that, hey, maybe that town that was doing some sketchy stuff, if you're the big town, you should have somehow been aware of something sketchy going on.
I do not know every little goings on in every town in the region.
Can we check to see if he's lying?
You can. That would be another sharps check, I guess.
Right. I want to do that.
Me too.
Yep, everyone.
19.
13.
Ooh, I got pretty high. 23.
But you also can't talk.
23. I can tell, though. 23.
Yeah. I got
like 20 and then plus 3?
19 plus 4.
Wait, did you get a nat 20, Beatrice?
No, I didn't.
I got 19, but plus 4.
I got 22.
None of you got
nat 20, though, or no?
No.
None got nat 20s. Just you all got really high.
Oh, wait. No, wait. 13, but I didn't add the addition thing. Hold on. Sorry.
Yeah. I got.
Alex, what did you get?
10.
Okay. I'm going to ignore you.
15. I got a 15.
The people who got over 17,
mm-hmm.
I think that's there's three of you, Dylan, Allie, and Opal, Haley.
Yep.
You all got over 17?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
All three of you can't. It's not obvious. Like, this is a career politician. He is good at speaking. He's good at keeping his thoughts to himself on a topic and just mm-hmm. putting forth a character in some ways. And you can see the lines here. You can see that he is carefully wording things so that he is not lying, but there's more going on than what he's saying.
Yeah, I don't.
Can I do a sharp check to see if I can hear like people coming down the hall to arrest us?
Oh yeah, Taylor, I forgot we didn't do that for you. You were going to check if there's anyone coming. I'm sorry. Do you want to do that now?
Sure. I didn't. I don't think I said that, but yes.
I thought you had. No, you said you were going to check to see if anyone's going to jump you.
Oh yes, there was that.
We never
too.
Did that, and this would be part of that. Let's do that.
Ooh, okay. I got 18 plus 3, so 21.
You actually don't really hear anyone else in the building. He had mentioned two other people, but you don't know where they are or what rooms they are. They're definitely not close to where you are at the moment.
Okay.
You don't...
Can I talk yet?
Give me one moment, Dylan. I just want to finish describing this. You can back. Opal, you do hear the movement of machinery, but it just seems like pipes and like stuff like that. You can't really place exactly what it is, but it doesn't sound... It probably is just some, just like pipes or heating or whatever. Like, there's not like, yeah.
Or maybe it's their fire making devices. I don't know. Okay, I'm gonna help Moon.
I think I can just talk. I mean, how long can a hand go over me?
Well, he got a nat 20, Dylan.
I mean, your decision, but.
Well, no, Dylan. Do you want to bite his hand?
Well, let's let Opal try this.
Okay, let me check here. What am I relating, like, adding to this?
Oh, are you trying to pull his hand off, or are you just, like...
I guess. I'm gonna, like...
You can also just be like, hey, you can stop that now.
Hey, stop that, Azure.
I sigh, and I see that the situation has already gotten a bit far, so I just let Chaos Reign and let my hand off.
Chaos Reign is your release move.
Moon, what were you trying to say?
Okay, but, like, Team Mocha, we need to have a talk here.
Group huddle.
Do you mind if we have the room, or can you point us to a room where we
just tell, like, hey,
we're a bit late for that.
There's the bathroom. Like,
we're all going to the bathroom at once, yeah. Okay? Is
that okay? We'll be back in a minute.
You hear a click, and you turn to the door, and you see bars come down over the door. Like,
oh, I knew it!
I prefer not leave.
I roll to restrain this guy. I move to restrain him.
You first have to make a dex. Actually, everyone make a dex save.
Okay.
Everybody.
This is why we shouldn't have gagged me, because I would have avoided the situation.
Nah, this is great.
You have to get over. All you have to tell me, guys, is who gets. Everyone roll. Everyone roll.
7,
8,
20.
19.
Nat 20, Dylan?
No, not Nat, but 20.
5.
Who got over 15?
Opal.
Me and Opal.
Opal and.
Me too.
And
you got as well, Harm?
I got 17.
Awesome. So, you three notice that similar bars, you notice spots on the ground where similar bars could come up, and you jump out of the way as they slam up into the ceiling, and they trap Kane and Azure in a, like a cage together.
This bitch is a cage out of the floor?
That could have, like, killed us. Easy.
It's for Faunus. He's a racist.
And he cut the two non-Faunuses.
Yeah.
No, I am. Okay, I am a Faunus.
Oh, no, you're a Faunus. Okay,
never mind.
But again, he doesn't know I'm a Faunus.
So you three are out of the cage at the moment. I'm not here to fight you. I just really would like to have the information you have.
Well, cages are not really friendly.
Can I restrain him?
Sure.
Can I assist? What do we roll? Or can we just do it? Because he's just a guy. Yeah.
Just a guy.
He's just a guy.
As you grab him, like, how are you trying to grab him?
I like to go from behind and, like, hold him and then put some tape over his mouth or something. Arm. Yeah, let's do that.
Where are you getting
As you both grab his arms or, like, put him behind him and you go to move to cover his mouth, he says, I wouldn't do that if I were you. As two, like, turrets appear out of the wall behind
him. Who is this guy?
Oh, shit. I thought this room was, like, kind of cozy. I'm assuming it's much bigger.
Okay, are we behind him there yet?
It's cozy, but, like, it's, hiding these things. Like,
Are those the only two turrets?
Are we behind him yet or no?
No, you were holding him from behind when the turrets came out.
We can just stick him in front of the turret, like,
well, are use the him other as a shield.
Dylan's fully ready to use human shields.
He's about to kill us. Yeah.
Wait, are they the only two turrets?
Yeah, there's only two, and they're both facing the same direction.
Are they facing us? Like, which direction are they?
Sorry. So, like,
we're holding him from behind. Which direction is he facing?
Okay, so Dylan, here's the room. Think of the door you came in as south. Okay, it's a square room. North is north from the door is the desk and all the bookcases, and to the west is a window facing the town, and the east is just a wall with more bookcases. A cage came up from the south side of the room around the door, trapping Kane and Kane and Azure. And to the north, two bookcases spun around to reveal turrets facing both south. Does that help?
So what we could do is we could spin around and hold him in front, because they're behind. They're not facing him. So we could try to spin around. Is that worth it? I think probably we could do that before. How are these going to fire? Like, he's not. We have him held. So I don't know. Who's controlling these things?
Knock them off the wall with my shield?
I mean, they're, like, wall-mounted. You'd have to, like, destroy them.
Can I do that?
I think the first of all, we should... Who's holding him? Me and Opal?
Yeah.
That's what I assumed.
We should spin around and have him face the turret first.
I agree. Quickly. I support this.
And you, like, hide behind him? Approach.
No, we're, like, holding him, and we just... 180.
Okay. That's fine. Nothing happens when you do that.
Okay. So now he would die if they're fired. Okay.
So, but more importantly, are the other guards there? Like, do we have to fight people?
No one's coming. You don't like.
Oh, they left.
So the question is someone controlling these things remotely?
Yeah, which I don't think you could really figure out.
Like,
yeah,
he's got a button or something.
Okay.
Decide as players if there's someone controlling.
Harm, can you do something about these turrets?
I think so. I could try to knock them off the walls and blow them up.
Try that.
Okay. How do I try that, DM?
You have to throw your. You're gonna try. Are you gonna try to throw your shield or like advance with your shield and try to like get up to them and punch them or something?
What do you guys think is a better idea? Should I throw my shield or should I like go punch them?
You should throw the shield. You don't want to be in front of them.
Can you throw the shield and like push it with more power?
Yes, I think so.
You could still have a shield. That's true.
Can I just offer? I also have my rifle. Can I shoot them from my cage area?
You can try to. Yeah. Also,
is the Grim in the cage?
Right. That's what I'm about to say.
Let's say he did. He roll a dexterity check.
He didn't make it.
Okay. And yes, he's in the cage.
Russ is just
don't
dead
believe
now.
Believe you, dear.
Kill it. He rolled a 14.
Oh, he did. Oh, he actually did roll. Okay.
Yes.
Okay. Up to you, Harm. What you want to do here?
Azure, do you want to try shooting it, and I can shield if that doesn't work?
Yeah, sure. Let me shoot at these turrets to see if that does anything.
Okay. Roll.
Everyone duck.
So first the d20, right?
Yeah, and you add your, I think for you, dex. Is that what we decided for you?
Yeah, so 8.
You only rolled an 8?
Yes.
That is not enough.
So I shoot a wall?
No, you shoot it, and it just kind of, like, it, like, hits it, but doesn't appear to do anything to the turret. You, like, hit just, like, solid metal.
Okay,
I'll try to throw the shield.
Unfortunately, at this point, the guns are now firing.
So okay, I'm gonna shield then.
Well, then everyone roll initiative. This is actually now combat.
Okay. Combat against gun turrets, let's see.
Wow.
What's our initiative modifier, or is it just straight up?
Straight.
I think it's just straight up. I think it's what we did last time.
Yeah. 8.
19.
10.
Oh, not 20.
Okay. A lot of help you'll be in that cage, but good.
I mean, I don't think I would be a lot of help. Say this, I have the worst luck with these dice. I think this is like they're plotting against me.
Moon, what did you roll?
19.
Azure, what did you roll?
8.
Harm, what did you roll?
11.
Thank you. Opal.
10.
Ooh. And Kane rolled a nat 20. A very helpful nat 20. All right. Kane, I'm going to say that you do go first.
Do you have any long range things?
She has pistols.
I mean, I have my guns.
I mean, it's not a big range. It's not really long range.
Can you use the whip to try and break the cage?
I mean, how, wrap around it and me yank the cage?
Yes.
Like how... I don't know if I'm that strong.
If you roll high enough, you might be.
Sturdy bars.
Yeah.
What if she rolls that?
You don't really need to make a strength, like a sharp check for that. Like these appear to be very, very sturdy. Like you can still try, but I mean, like they look strong.
No, I don't want to try. I believe you when you say that. Can I, like, I want to? Can I use like my? Do I have to do an action? Can I just like? Be calmly sit there because I'm like
no. You don't have to do something if you don't think you can do something that is helpful. Like you can just decide like you want to like make sure you don't get shot or something like that.
Yeah, I'll do that.
Okay, you can just say like, hey, I'm just gonna be ready to dodge bullets if they come at me because that's a thing you can do in Ruby.
Well, that's my thing. We're all like jump to like the corner of the cage or to another corner, just dodging the bullets because I am in a cage and I can't.
Are you gonna be stupidly like deflecting them with your daggers?
Yeah, I can do that.
Yeah, like okay. Stupid anime style.
Yeah, let's do that.
Okay.
Do I have to roll something?
We can roll something if they attack you, but you will get advantage when they attack you if that's all you're doing.
Okay, cool.
Like, yeah, if they do attack you. We'll have to wait and see on that.
Also, I kind of want to stay out of the way because I feel like this is my fault.
Moon, it is your turn.
You don't say.
Well, no, yeah. Kane, I want to make sure you know this is 100% your fault.
Wait, like, no, no. Look, this is Alex's fault because if I was not restrained, I would have stopped her. But okay, and okay, my turn.
Yes.
So I have a question. So I'm holding him. Yeah. Can I? I have my bow. Can I shoot my bow while holding him? And if not, does transferring him to Opal take a turn, or can I do that and shoot at the same time?
I mean, like, Opal's holding him too. Like, if you let go, he'd have an arm free. But I mean, like, he's still just a guy.
Okay. Can I shoot while holding him? Probably not.
No.
Okay. So I think I'm pretty useful here because I can shoot a nice arrow at them and freeze
them. Hold on. Do you have a tail?
I do have a tail, yeah. Ooh. Oh, hold him with my tail. Ooh, yeah, let's do it. Wait, can I fire my bow with my tail? I like that.
I'll say not yet, but that is something we can talk about in... We can talk about...
I can at least hold his arm with my tail.
Yes, you can. But as you level up, we can talk about you having one of your things be that your tail gets more useful in combat.
Okay, I like it. Okay. Okay, I'm gonna arm to tail. Tail's holding him. Try to shoot an ice arrow at the turret and try to freeze it.
Okay. Roll to hit.
Okay. What am I adding? Or just normal?
What's your normal? I think you have attack modifier in your sheet. I forget what we decided for you.
Oh, is it my main one?
Yeah, it's your main attack then.
Whatever is like sharp or dex or yeah. It's 11 plus 15.
So 15? That's enough. Yeah, you hit the turrets just fine. Full damage.
Is it effect? I feel like it's more about effect for this, but
yeah. But they still have health. They're still a thing.
Okay. I rolled a 1d8 five plus dust effects.
Yes, and the dust effect for ice is a freezing effect. If you hit, what did you roll for damage?
5.
Okay. So as long as you roll higher than average on a d8, your dust effect has a full effect on it, essentially. So you have frozen this turret for
yes. Okay. We'll see if it breaks out by shooting. I'm worried about
yeah.
that. But.
Yeah, but so like if you get below half, like the effect.
Okay. Is less gotcha. Effectively.
But yeah, you all did right. 5 damage and you froze this turret.
Nice. Okay. Cool. Who's next?
Up next is me. The turret's turn. Also, just you know, were you?
Are these sentient turrets?
Yes. Are you attacking the left or the right turret, Dylan? Did you?
Attack which side am I on?
That's up to you. Which side of the guy did you grab?
If I'm on the left side, I attack the left turret.
Right, let's just say you're on the left side then.
Okay.
And you attack the left turret and dealt 5 damage. Now it's my turn. The turret that's frozen is still able to move. So it seems that freezing it does not stop whatever is in it, but it does stop it from being able to hit anybody this turn. It uses its turn to shoot and break the ice that's around it, but it doesn't do anything else. Nice. And the other turret turns and turns to Alex.
Okay, because I'm in a cage. Sure.
Azure.
Did I need to like do some roll to like see if I avoid it?
No, that's I forget what your AC is. I'm sorry.
My aura?
No, your AC. I forget how we did AC last week. Sorry. I remember now. This is a. Okay, I have your sheet. I know what you are. Yeah, this hits you. This hits you, Alex.
Okay. I have been shot.
Is he dead? I can't like jump in front of him and like, try and do the knife
get
thing.
Get Aura, guys.
Oh, Auras. That's right. We can get shot and be fine.
Yeah, shot in this world.
Sorry,
Alex. You take 8 damage.
Oh,
okay.
Is that not Aura?
That's Aura.
Okay. Yeah.
Our listeners are supposed to be confused about Aura. You guys aren't supposed to be confused. You guys,
I don't get the AC part.
Yeah, you called it AC, so I was. Oh, okay.
AC is different. AC is whether you're hit or not.
Okay.
Wait, was it 8 or 7?
8
damage.
Okay.
Yeah, I did, right. Okay.
Alex takes 8 damage. It is now someone else's turn. Harm.
Okay.
I think I'm going to try throwing my shield first at the one with ice to see if I can like knock it off and make it explode.
Wait, so it only shot me on that turn?
Yeah, it only had one attack.
Wow.
It doesn't like children.
Well, the right one shot perfect. Alex, but the left one broke out of being frozen already.
But I mean, it's still there's still some ice on it. That's what I assumed.
Wait, so do I roll dex for this?
You roll strength because you're throwing. You're like, it's more like a javelin type throw. Like, this is a strength based throw.
Okay. 17
to hit?
Yeah.
That hits.
Yay. Wait, what do I do after that? I forgot.
Let me look at your sheet. So you roll a d6.
Okay. Plus two. Wait, no.
Plus strength.
Okay. Okay, okay, okay. Six.
Six damage?
Yeah.
Cool. You deal six damage to this turret, and you still have a bonus action, so you can call the shield back this turn.
I will do that. Absolutely.
Okay. So you dealt six damage, and that is your turn, unless you want to move. If you want to move somewhere, though, there's not really anywhere to move to.
Can I move, to whoever's in front of the right turret and just hold my shield up?
So you want to move over to Opal?
Yeah.
Okay. You can do that.
I'll hold the shield.
Yeah, so you're leaving a moon defenseless.
Well, he has his bow, and he can jump. He's a cat.
Which one did Allie attack?
Allie attacked the same one you did, Dylan.
Okay, it's not dead?
It's not dead. It is sparking a bit, though.
Okay.
It'll be okay. I trust you, Moon.
You are up.
Oh, gosh. Okay. Maybe.
Oh, wait, I should have a action to hold that dude.
Can I do a dexterity? No, that's never mind. Wrong thing. But maybe I can shoot into the
barrel
hole of it, the barrel of it,
the hole of it.
I don't know.
The barrel of the gun.
Yeah, is that a thing I could do? I don't know.
You can try. That requires a lot more dexterity.
I've got four.
Go for it.
Okay. What do I just
roll a d20 with dex?
Okay. Ooh, I only got 18 in total.
Oh, you were so close.
Oh! Darn it. Okay. Do I do anything else?
No, that counts as your attack.
I'm sorry, guys, but I'm still holding the guy down, so that's good.
Your bullet bounces off the barrel of the gun, and it does kind of, dent the edge of it, but it does no real damage to the
target. It doesn't, rebound into Azure again?
No, it does not.
Okay, good.
It does not. Don't give me ideas, but it does not. Azure, it is now your turn again.
Okay, so should I try shooting it again? Or...
I mean, you can do whatever you want.
I got an idea. We gotta go after the guy now.
Do you just want to kill the guy? I mean, we could kill him right now.
No, we need to get information out of him.
Isn't it my turn? Are we doing the new, circle, or is it no? We haven't finished the original.
No, I haven't attacked it. I've just been shot.
We need more information.
That's what happened. My bad.
So Grim, are they able to phase through bars?
No.
Why would they
be able to phase through bars?
I don't know. Like in Ruby Chibi, they're kind of like ghosts. So I wasn't sure that extended to.
Are we dealing in D&D of the Ruby Chibi world?
I don't know.
I feel like this is more of a Ruby TV world.
That changes everything.
I want all my options open, okay? But fine. So I don't know. I guess I'll... Because my rifle can convert into a trident. So, I don't know if, that would be more useful in this situation. And, if I miss, then I just lose my weapon for this entire thing. So... I guess I'll just do the rifle. I'll just shoot at one of the turrets again and see what happens. Let's see. I rolled a 5.
I'm just moving on from you, Alex.
Yeah, good job, me.
Or do you want to do anything or just continue just blocking?
Can I, threaten? So can I turn one of the daggers into a pistol?
Yeah.
And point it at the guy and be like, okay, let's see what's faster, my finger or your turret.
Dang.
I don't know. Threaten him, So roll, it's not kill roll. Him, but be like, pull, like basically point my pistol at him and be like, put the turrets away.
Roll
we'll
charisma.
Stand down and then you like, you know.
Yeah, roll intimidation, which is a charisma check.
Okay. Oh god.
Yeah, your charisma's not good.
I got with charisma, I got with charisma 13.
He does not seem concerned at all. He just kind of
ready to die.
He also is not facing you, Kane.
Okay.
You can't really see what his face looks like when you say this.
Okay.
But you are pointing your gun at him.
All right. Well, that was the move. Right? I can't do anything else.
He doesn't. Nothing changed in the room. But yeah. Sorry, nothing really happened.
Okay. I tried.
Yeah. I mean, you can't really do much else from the cage.
Yeah.
Up next is Moon. You're up again.
Okay. I wonder if lightning arrows would do better against them than ice arrows.
Mm. Ooh, maybe. Yeah. You know, like over, like, you know, like
make it short circuit. Yeah. I'm gonna try to finish off the left one.
Okay. Roll to hit.
You got this.
We'll see. 17.
You hit.
Okay.
And you use lightning dust?
Yeah. For damage, I got a 2.
Okay. So you hit this turret, but the effect is not as strong as the ice.
Damn it.
Like in general. But it does actually cause the turret to like shake a bit. Like it kind of jerks back and forth a little bit. And it doesn't look good for the turret what's happening.
Hmm. Okay.
It's not dead, but we'll see what happens on its turn.
Okay. I think this is like confusion.
Like, what's the Pokemon song? It's like random encounter. Anyway. The turret doesn't do anything on its turn. The one you hit, Dylan.
Okay. Ooh. Yeah.
And the other one misses both its shots at Azure.
Yay.
So nothing happens in that. Well, it doesn't miss. I'll be nice and say Azure dodged the shots because this is anime. But I think that's putting a little too much.
This is not anime, but okay.
It was an easy thing to dodge, is what you're saying.
Yeah. Okay. Yes. Harm, you're up. And Dylan, how dare you say this is not anime?
It's not anime. First of all, this is D&D. Second of all, Ruby's not anime.
Moving on. Harm, what are you doing?
If I throw my shield, can I ricochet it to hit the other one also, or it will just hit one?
You can try. It's a harder throw.
Would I have to roll any different?
No, but you just have to roll a higher number.
Okay, I'm going to try that. I'm going to go for the left one first.
Okay.
16.
You do not hit both of them.
Do I hit one of them?
I mean, you hit one of them.
Okay, that's okay.
You roll damage, but you don't add your strength modifier this time.
What?
Because when you threw it, you're kind of aiming for a less than optimal place on the turret to make it bounce, so you do a little bit less damage.
Damn. Okay, hold on.
For the record, if you'd rolled high enough, you wouldn't have had this negative thing. But this is a negative for trying to do both.
Oh, okay, I get that. Okay. I rolled a 6, though, for a damage.
You rolled just naturally highest damage?
Yeah. Oh, wait, is that the highest you can get?
You rolled a d6, didn't you?
Yeah. Oh, that's what it means.
Oh. Allie!
No, I've played D&D, like, twice outside of this.
I'm just moving on. The turret is like sparking.
I don't have actual dice. I'm using the online thing.
But it's called a D6.
I don't know.
Opal, it's your turn.
Wait, is it not dead?
It's sparking and spewing smoke. But
it will never die.
It really won't.
Okay. I'm going to. Let's see. What can I do? I'm going to. Take the attention away from the turrets and bring back to the dude. And can I like check him for some sort of button or something that he's using to make all this happen?
Yeah, roll. What do you think you would roll to like quick search him?
Investigation.
Is that a thing?
Which stat? No, which stat though? Do you think?
Oh, yeah. Dexterity, because it's my highest.
Buy that. Yeah, just how quickly. Yeah. You want. Sure. Go ahead.
Okay. Cool. Okay, I got 18 again in total.
You kind of do like a pat down and you find like pens and normal stuff you'd see in a politician's pockets, like a wallet and a phone and stuff like that. But you don't see any like remote for this or anything like that.
Can I do like a part two of this?
What do you mean a part two?
Can I like glance at the desk?
Yeah, I'll say you still can't do that.
Okay. Should I use sharp for that?
Yeah, this will be sharp, and this will probably be the end of your turn.
Okay, yeah, that's fair. Ooh, I only got 7 in total, so...
You don't see it, the desk just looks like a desk. You don't really see anything weird about it. Like, I mean, there's unique things to it. Like, there's specific, like, pen holders and like he has like candy on there for to give to people, stuff like that. But I mean, nothing like that looks.
See, I'm suspicious of the contact lens thing, guys, because those are not a thing in Ruby, and he seemed.
Why do you think they're not a thing in Ruby? What do you mean? Wait. What do you mean they're not a thing in Ruby?
It's not a thing. People don't wear contact. That's too modern. They may have phones, but they don't have contact lenses.
Fucking cell phones.
We've not seen anyone putting contacts.
They
on
have
the show.
Gun, multiple weapons, but no contacts.
Yeah, that just seems too practical for them. That's not what they would
focus on. Have, like,
she's not wrong, kind of.
No. Like, I feel like that's a cover-up for something. He was, like, under the desk, like, oh, they're coming. I got to hide that weird thing I'm using as tech. And then he was like, my contacts. And they're like, what? It's my theory.
Anyways, Opal, you're...
But I'm done. My turn.
It is your turn to do whatever you want again.
Well-being.
I'm not smart, so I guess I'll just shoot again.
The one on the left or the right?
Which one is the one that's more damaged?
The one on the left. The one on the right is not hurt at all yet.
Okay, let's do the left one since I don't have confidence.
You roll a number for 10. That's the real question.
5.
Okay, we're just moving on from Alex.
Yeah, there. Okay.
All right, everyone, can everyone make a sharps check? Like, everybody,
yes.
All 5 of you.
Yes.
Oh, okay. A what check?
Sharps.
Sure.
Nat 20.
Nice.
I got...
Oh, damn.
8.
11.
I got 6 and 7, so 13.
Got over 17.
Oh, no, sorry, not 7. I'm making things up. I got 9.
Who got over 17?
Me.
Me.
Allie, you got over 17?
I got a 19. I don't know.
Okay. Sorry. I need to roll another number. That's all. So Dylan and Allie, you are focused on the turrets when all of a sudden you kind of feel a shift in the room. And you don't know why, but you feel like somebody is... or some, maybe more than one person, is in the room with you now, all of a sudden.
Semblance.
What if it's the musicians?
I doubt it.
Yeah, probably.
Could it be?
Mist, yeah. She turns into mist. That's her semblance.
Yeah. Oh, that's logical.
Also, Dylan, you got a nat 20?
Yeah.
And you kind of, like, shake... Allie, you don't even notice this, but Dylan, with your nat 20, you, like, kind of shake your head, and... you realize the window's closed, but you just felt a breeze brush over your arm.
Eerie. Maybe it actually is her.
Like, yeah.
I don't know what to do about this.
Me neither. Guys,
I think we're getting captured.
Going on.
Can we get? What if we broke out of this room and then ran?
Can we even?
Try to shoot a hole in the side of it. Could jump out the window. I don't know.
Is there a window?
Leave Kane and Azure.
Oh, they're in a cage.
We'll be back to you later.
Break out Dylan, of the cage. Dylan, yeah. We're just moving on. Moving on because we're not progressing.
Yeah, I mean, so is the left turret able to shoot?
Oh, no. I'm doing something. That's what I'm saying.
Oh, you're doing something.
I'm doing something before you have a chance to talk too much more. That's all I was trying to say.
Okay.
That is all I am trying to say. Just so you know what the full thing going on is. I don't want you to plan too much stuff and then not have anything happen. In this moment where you realize the air is brushing against your arm, you glance towards the window because it should be closed. And in that moment when you glance over, an arrow just kind of goes through the window, not breaking it, just goes through where the window is. And there's kind of a rippling effect through there. And the arrow strikes you. And you got lucky. You only take one damage. You rolled really lucky. You only take one damage from this arrow as it bounces off your aura.
Who, me?
Yeah, you.
Dang. Why me?
You're the closest to the window. You're on the left side of him.
Okay, so there's a random arrow came out.
Yes.
And hit me.
Yes.
Uh-oh. From the window.
From the window.
Through
the window.
There
was like a shimmer thing.
Yes, and there was a shimmer.
Okay.
Question. Why do people like... Am I the only one who... Am I weird for not liking circuses?
Not at all. You're actually in the majority.
Dylan! Wait, no, Beatrice!
No, I mean, where did that come from? It's a fair question because media portrays the circus as something.
Put that question into the podcast because it needs to go in. I am so shocked.
I had no idea I didn't even understand the context, but okay.
Because they're talking about Dumbo. And
yeah, no, a lot of people don't like circuses.
Like, I am totally, Dylan, we need to shove that into the podcast.
We're back from break now, so just make that the start of coming back.
Yeah,
okay.
So that's the start. That's where we're coming in.
Okay.
We're pulling away the veil here, listeners, that we take a break in the middle, because what is this, Beatrice?
There was context, but I didn't understand it.
No, there was no context. There's no real context.
There was context. We were talking about Dumbo.
Yeah,
and Dumbo. Beatrice brings up an excellent point that circuses are portrayed in media as like this happy experience, when in reality, a lot of us don't like circuses or the idea, whether it be for the creepy clowns, whether it be for the treatment of animals. There's a lot of like little things about circuses that make people uncomfortable, but yet the general idea of a circus is, oh, this is entertainment. So that's kind of a real dissonance in like how media portrays the circus even today versus when you break it down all like the little stuff. There's lots of people who don't enjoy those kind of things.
Thanks for that TED talk, Alex. Let's go back to playing D&D now.
Are there circuses?
I really appreciate it because Alex got it.
Is there a situation right where like Grimm have been abused in this society and like uses like circus animals for entertainment?
You're saying that this is an in-character thing?
Yeah, because like that would be very bad if that happened.
Guys, I just sent you my beautiful work.
did you say?
Yep.
That's the screen cap, JK. Yeah.
I was inspired earlier when we were like, he's the god. Well, okay. Now we know who the real god is. We're
actually back right now. I was trying to actually do the combat.
Sorry.
Yeah, this is Andy's face pasted on the light.
The god of light.
We somehow transitioned into a drunk pod. I don't know how that's possible.
Mm. I know how it's possible.
Sorry, I'm back.
I guess we're just going to start here.
Okay.
I guess
you guys start without me?
Yeah, we didn't do anything.
Not really.
Beatrice said something completely absurd, and I want.
Oh my gosh, it was not completely absurd.
It was just funny without really realizing the context.
Yeah, you ignored my whole eloquent explanation of why it wasn't absurd. So
stop being mean to me.
Stop being mean to Cain.
Beatrice, don't ask me to do that before we get to the end of this session, because I'm not done yet.
Oh God.
Is it my? I have something to do. Is it in the game? Is it my turn?
Yeah, it's your turn now. Now that you've been hit by this arrow. It's
okay, but hit by an arrow that came out of a window
that shimmered as it came through.
Okay. Ooh. So I take my bow, hold it up to this guy's head, and shout at the room. Listen up, everybody who's attacking us. I know you're out there. You better stop the fuck right now, or I'm gonna kill this guy right in front of you.
Holy shit!
You better stop!
There's gun turrets in the ceiling attacking us, and ghost arrows? We are going to kill this bitch. Stop right now.
We were supposed to be guests at your house.
Okay, is the first time Cain has heard Moon curse.
Yeah, no, it is
so viciously. So Cain is just on the floor cackling.
Moon, roll an intimidation check, charisma.
I mean, I have a thing up to his head. I mean, I feel like it's pretty intimidating.
She's very proud of Moon.
Charisma, 21 total.
21 total?
My rolls have been very good. Yeah,
they've been really good. I really like what you just did there. You're going to get inspiration for that.
Hell yeah.
Yes. Okay.
For anyone doesn't know, for the players don't know, inspiration is a thing as a DM I can give you if I think you did something funny or good or just creative. And when you have it, it's something you can spend to just get advantage on a roll. Essentially, I just reward you for role-playing or doing fun things. That's all. Okay.
Question. Can you punish us for doing things?
I think we would have been punished by now. I think.
Yeah. Some of us deserve more punishment.
That's what this the punishment is, that you're in a combat here because you did stuff to this guy.
All right. I mean, I just yelled at him. He didn't have to attack us with turrets.
And then never mind. I'm not going into the whole thing because that pulls back the veil a little too much. But the point is, I do punish you, Beatrice, but it's, anyways, moving on. Dylan, you do this. You're not sure right now what happens, because I mean, no one attacks you, but you're not sure if what they're doing outside.
Okay.
So hopefully it worked.
It's tough because we don't know if it worked. I still would like to shoot the thing if it's going to attack us again, but...
You're kind of in a... You're caught in a place where it's like you're kind of in a
state. I would back out of the room if we didn't have two people in a cage.
Yeah.
Well, we can come back for them.
You want to ditch them?
We'll be fine.
They can't do anything.
So is this the way you're going to end your turn, Dylan?
Yeah, I guess so.
I need to know because that changes things depending on how you end your turn.
I'll end the turn there, yeah.
Okay. As you do this, as you put this arrow to his head and just show that you're seriously like going to stay like this and do this, two people shimmer into existence in the room with you. They don't like teleport. It looks like they were just hidden from view from you. And I guess that's it. They're shrouded figures wearing like hoods and robes, like dark colors covering their face and bodies. One of the figures speaks up and says to you, "We'd really appreciate if you do not kill him.
Tell us who the fuck you are first and stand down those turrets.
Each of you roll a sharps check first.
Okay.
Everybody?
Oh, yes. No. I only got 4.
14. Tell me if he gets above a 15.
Oh, no.
Okay, hold on.
Not me.
I got sharp. I got 14. Oof.
Okay, no one got over 15?
Nope.
Okay, so we continue with this. The person in front of you who you can't really tell who they are or what they are, like their voice is kind of modulated, like by some kind of device, kind of hidden from you, so you don't. They came here prepared to hide their identity, is what I'm trying to say. And they put up both their hands and they just go, "Let's calm down. No one needs to die here."
Where are those turrets going then? And also, there's a cage around our friends.
Let's calm down. The turrets can go away. And as this person says that, the turrets hide back in the bookcase. I'm going to keep the cage here, though. There's a lot of you. There's only two of us. We're just going to calm down.
Okay, I'm calm, but I still got this arrow to his head.
you're calmly threatening.
I'm calmly about to kill him, so yeah. Continue.
Gotta keep your advantage.
There are things happening here that you don't understand.
Enlighten us.
Yeah, what's happening?
This is really... You just have to turn around and forget you were ever here or saw any of this. That's all you need to do.
Yeah, I'm the one asking that the cage goes down. So we might be glad to do that.
All we want... We work for him. We don't want you to talk about Ram's Horn to anybody. Just go back. You can stay here the night and then leave Green Grove. And no one has to die. None of this fighting has to happen.
You know, that sounds good to me. I'll believe you when we're out of danger. Our friends are free, and maybe then I'll release him.
I really cannot let you.
Who are you? I'm so confused.
We don't know.
This
yet.
Is me talking, not harm.
Okay. Dylan, so you continue to hold him captive?
Yeah, I think we have to. Does anyone disagree?
No.
Nope.
That's what makes this difficult.
Yeah. So, you're not going to let him go. I'm not going to let your friends go or you leave this room with him. So it seems we're at an impasse here.
I do not believe this is an impasse. I think we have more leverage here if your boss is the one who we have captive here.
I think you severely underestimate who you're dealing with right now.
I mean, you haven't told us, so I have no concept to no ability to over or underestimate.
sorry. Look, I'm not going to explain who we are because that would defeat the purpose of who we are. If I told you, then we wouldn't be a secret.
Look, this is some Illuminati shit. Okay, that's fine. We just want to get out of here. Can you lower the cage?
But I'm not giving you a 5-on-2 advantage here.
I am a nice person. I do not want to kill your
we
boss.
Can't leave
I'm just imagining.
Yeah.
I'm imagining Moon yelling, "I'm a nice person," as you hold a bow and arrow into somebody's head.
That's what's happening.
Yep.
I don't want to.
I weakly raise my hand and go, "I can vouch for that."
If you want further proof that we do not mean harm here, there's some musicians who just came into town. We helped them get here. You can also contact this other town that we just saved.
Check our references.
You're the one that pulled guns on us after we were telling you the truth. I think we're not the ones who need to calm down.
Also, you brought us here.
Also, you led us here. Yeah, that is a good point.
Like, we didn't want to come. We were happy to go to the bar with her buddy.
What's her name with the Y in her name? Get her back. Get her back here. She liked us. Get Arl back here. She'll vouch for us.
Arl, get her back.
The issue is that you are nice. You're a little too nice.
The fuck does that mean?
So you're suspicious of us. You're the ones with the secret organization.
No, it's more that we know how you'll act, and we don't like that.
If you reveal the shadowy truth to us, we don't need to know. I'm fine leaving intact, okay? But that requires the cage coming down.
But see, if we let you go, you'll just try to save people some other way, and
save who? What do you mean?
We don't know that you're putting people in danger yet. You're revealing your hands here.
You are the cause of the fires.
You see the person in front of you just kind of clench their fist, and as they you can tell that they're getting really annoyed with this whole
rightly so.
They turn to the other shrouded figure and just say, can you deal with this? I really cannot do this today.
Like frustrating Illuminati people.
Guard banter, yeah.
Yeah, I dealt with the last ones. You really should do this one. But these ones are so annoying. These ones are so, so fucking annoying.
We can hear you.
We're right here.
Yeah, we know you can hear us. This guy's just a wimp, and he won't deal with you because he's just whinging. Fine. You fucking just go stand by the window. I'll deal with this then. The other strata figure stands forward. Look. We killed a lot of people like you. All right? Probably going to kill you at some point. If you want to live for a few more months, just leave.
We'll leave.
But you open the gate down.
Really? Again,
all of us.
Really not a
will
good
leave.
Thing telling us you kill a bunch of people.
Yeah,
it shouldn't be what the information you're revealing is. But it's fine. We'll still leave, okay?
Look, I'm going to open the door and the cage. You're going to let go of him and walk out.
Okay, cool.
Okay, we'll let go of him as soon as we all leave the room.
No, the four of them leave with you. You let him go before you leave the room.
Well, we're going to walk at least over to the door.
We need the cage people out before we let him go.
Yeah.
Yeah, on three.
Exactly.
On three what?
Let the cage go and we will let him go.
No.
The cage
go first, yeah.
So you want me to count to three and then open the cage?
Okay, yes. We'll count to three. On three, the cage goes down. On zero, we let him go.
Wait, are Moon and I and the dude away from the door? That doesn't make sense.
So it's even, right?
On three, and then we go back to zero.
The other shrouded figure put the hand to their shrouded face. And
one, two,
like,
three, zero.
Holy shit.
On go.
Oh my god. I'm not going to count to three. I will open the cage.
Yes. Okay, we're in agreement then.
I will open the cage.
Yes, good.
My friend here will walk over and grab one of his arms. The guy you're going to kill.
Okay.
You will let go of his other arm and walk with your friends out the door.
Okay.
Fine. No, I want us to walk over to the door with the guy.
He's in the doorway. One arm in the room, one arm out of the door.
I don't want to release the other arm.
We'll release the other arm.
How did you survive this long?
Well, we've beaten you so far.
Wait, are we out? Are we out of the cage yet?
No! You guys are still in the cage? I'm not putting the cage yet. You guys are stupid!
You're the ones getting outsmarted by us, okay?
I'm not being outsmarted by you. We're being outstupided. I didn't think people this stupid could do this.
Cage down, and we'll give you one arm, okay?
The shrouded figure that you're talking to now turns to him and turns to the other shrouded figure and just goes, "What? You fucked this up and gave me this shithole, okay?"
Interesting.
Wait, who's the shithole?
You guys.
Oh, us.
Or maybe better way to say this situation.
Situation.
Thanks.
Okay, thanks. Is the cage, thanks. Let the cage down. I mean, fuck.
Let's just begin this process.
Okay. Opening the cage. We're not going to do the stupid one arm in, one arm out thing. Are we? Is that?
Whatever. Just lower the cage and I'll throw him to you.
Yeah.
No, you're not going to throw him to me.
Oh my god.
I'll shove him in your direction.
I'll throw him. I can gentle.
You know what? Fine. And then at this point, the Biz just goes like, wait, do I get a say in this? No, you do not get a say in this because these five people are very stupid.
Hey, I take offense to that.
We are fine hunters and huntresses, I'll have you know.
I need to take a shit soon, so please get me out of here.
Just hold it, okay?
You've also been, like, shot. God.
Exactly. I have less control over my bodily functions right now.
You're doing well.
The second shrouded figure just kind of like tilts their head back and looks towards the ceiling. It's like, please God, if they shit in this room, I don't know what.
What is happening? Look,
he's not going to hold it, so you better let us go right now.
Oh my God! All right. I will open the cage just because I don't want you to shit on the fucking floor.
Thank Probably you. A good call. Probably.
Much appreciated, sir.
Okay, I'm going to open the cage first, but not unlock the door yet. That's.
Oh my god.
The cage is open. The bars go the bars of the cage go down. The door is still barred. Okay, all right.
From that spot. Come to us.
What'd you say, Dylan?
Freedom.
Talking to the Kane and Alex and Azure. Yeah.
Okay.
They move.
Okay.
Go to the door.
Yeah, Dylan, you phased out there.
Move out of the spot where the cage comes up.
Okay.
Okay. Yes.
I moved. I helped. Azure because he's shot. You know.
Yeah, I'm shot and about to poop.
He's shot, but he's fine because.
Oh right, his aura. All right, never mind.
Oh my god. Anyways,
okay. On three, unlock the door. We'll shove him to you. Okay.
One.
Do we have to count?
Two.
Look, I'm going to do it from five unless we do three, okay? Oh it's just God. Going up.
One, two, three.
Zero.
Is the door unlocked?
Wait. Allie, you still zero?
That's what Moon said before. We let the cage goes up on three, we let him go on zero.
Zero.
I'm going to ignore that. It's just say that
plan.
Listen, I'm just going to the store.
Okay,
to the
you guys,
store.
You hooded figure number two, you count.
Fine.
This is still going.
Just count, dude.
Two. Three. Okay, Dylan, before I say what happens, do you throw the guard, the guy at her?
I move my arms back with the intention to shove him forward.
No. I need to know what you're doing because it's at the moment that the button would be pressed, okay?
I'm doing this too, right? Because I'm also holding
him. Yeah. Are you both going to do it? Like this?
We're
is,
like shoving him, yeah.
You have to I think we're shoving him hard with the intention of him toppling over onto the hooded figure.
And then we jump over him and run out the door. That's
so you are going to do it. Like that's what I'm saying. Like
We're going to do it, yeah. We're going to do it.
You need to know. I need to know you're doing it before you
We're
going
to do it. We're going to do it.
Okay.
Yes.
Okay.
Maybe not a good idea.
You do that. You push the guy. He kind of hits the floor, but I mean, like, he's whatever. The door does get unbarred, and you can leave.
Okay, we run out.
Yeah, fine. Everyone let's run. Go. Okay.
Later, Biz.
Harm last, who puts a shield up over us.
Yes, she does.
Okay. Yeah, good. I almost said good job, but I mean...
almost good job.
As you leave, you hear one of the hooded figures. You can't tell which one. They appear to be talking to Biz, and they're like, "You're so stupid."
Yep.
Yeah, we gotta get the
this
fuck
is
out
so
of here.
Boring. Okay, let's. We can we exit the building?
What do you mean this is so boring?
Biz was so boring, so he deserves that.
Oh, Biz was so boring.
Yeah, Biz was boring.
Okay.
Do we exit the building?
Yeah, you can...
Guys, we should head to that bar that the musicians were talking about. I don't think they'll look
should we there. Even... I feel like we should get the fuck out of Dodge.
Well, either we leave the town or we'll go to some random bar, because I don't think they'll find us there.
Okay. We should go to the musicians, because maybe they know what Biz's deal is. Okay. Like, who he actually is.
Or we could warn them, be like, hey, this place isn't as boring as you thought. Maybe you should head out.
Okay. I also have a speech to give the team when we can get to private.
Why don't you give it now? You know, while there's nothing happening... I feel like something could turn bad. This is a good time to give a speech.
Okay.
As we're walking?
Yeah, just like, you know, scold at us. Whatever you need to do, just do it now.
Oh, my gosh.
Well, what's happening right now?
You're leaving the building. Like, are you going
to... Are we outside?
Yeah, you got outside.
Have we been kicked out?
I think by speech, he means backstory stuff.
No.
Oh, so
no,
not
no, no,
in-game?
No, no. I know what Dylan means. I know he 100% means an actual speech.
Oh, never mind.
Okay.
Are we walking to the bar?
We're walking to the bar, right? Okay. Is it okay? Nothing's happening?
Yeah. I mean...
Are we running to the bar?
I'm looking around nervously because you think something will happen.
Okay. Team Mocha here. I feel very justified, the speech I was about to give, given what happened, but... First of all, we're a new team. I know you guys think I'm some joke here, but I've been appointed team leader by myself and
and Kane apparently.
And apparently Kane and Kane supports us. We need to trust each other, okay? No gagging each other as we're trying to talk. We're all contributing to the survival of Team Mocha and whatever nonsense goal that we are trying to achieve here. Apparently, fighting the Illuminati is what this campaign is about. We need to trust each other. And support all of us, okay? That's the first thing. Do we agree?
I agree.
Yes.
We just been through shared trauma of gun turrets and a cage dropping from a small room. So,
we agree. Agreement.
Okay.
I trust you as far as I can throw you, and I think I can throw you pretty far.
Okay, that's a good line. Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. So, do our team trust each other? Second of all, to the humans of the group. We need to be careful with what we saw last campaign about, last session about the Weifang and the elder. Cause Azure, you're probably not too familiar with this yet, because you just came out of the island, but, there's systemic racism in this world. And, I experienced this firsthand. I haven't told you guys this, but, humans in Menagerie killed my parents, and I am, none too kind. I don't hate humans, but we should be suspicious of what they're doing here, and we should not be forthcoming with information about Faunuses, because I think that organization is part of some anti-Faunus activities. They're probably part in cahoots with that elder. Maybe we might have seen if there's like this secret Faunus hating organization, the Faunus KKK across Menagerie.
Oh,
is that what Andy's doing? Like, then
the
we need to be, we need the FFF. What? No, we need to be careful with who we're telling stuff and be aware of the system of prejudice against Faunus in this world. And we need to trust each other. This is what I have to say here. Okay.
I agree. Especially the part about the Faunuses, because also we have an ex member of the White Fang here. Y'all need to be careful.
And even though the White Fang attacked them, we don't think the White Fang is bad yet, because this is pre-Ruby, so... No.
But it's still a Faunus group, and they are discriminated against.
But my theory now is that maybe this weird Illuminati crew is pinning these attacks on the White Fang.
Mm.
Yeah, because they want something.
Oh, wow, maybe it wasn't even the White Fang, yeah.
It really is Illuminati shit.
Yeah.
Okay. Does anyone have other things to say about what I said? We each have a say.
But some says are more equal than others, Dylan.
No, it's fine. I just look.
I'll just say Harm has a lot of respect for Moon after that speech, and she's like trying not to cry.
And I, as a not Faunus, I commend you on your bravery, and I support you.
Azure, are you okay with all that? I know you're human. Was that offensive?
With all due respect, I I sympathize with your plight of having lost your parents, but frankly, I need to take a shit. I need to take a drink.
Oh,
and
I
need
to forget that's right. I forgot about that. Let's get to
the I thought you were kidding.
So
oh my god.
To walk away. Let's get to the. Let's go to the bar and
you can take a shit in the
bar. So, apologies that I didn't really pay attention to your speech because right now I'm just not in the place for this right now. Okay.
But he likes Grimm, so he's got to like fun us.
Yeah.
Can't
I can't believe you'll we're understand. Babysitting. Okay, well, I'll repeat. I'll repeat the speech after we get to the bar. Okay.
Alex, roll a strength check for me.
To keep his shit inside of him?
Just roll strength check.
10.
No. Shit, your pants.
Fart.
I fart? Is that, the question?
No, you let loose a giant fart.
Okay, good.
Andy, why are we going to bring fart jokes?
I'm going to blow it away, please.
It's not a fart joke. This is just Alex has a horrible life.
Well, what happens is I walk away from this group, and as I'm walking away, I let out a loud fart.
So you just leave the fart with us?
Yep.
And you
can I amplify it? Like to
why would you
so like why blow it into the house it? And make them all pass out or something?
Ooh, that's a good idea.
Okay, I like how Dylan was offended by the fart joke, and I was like, "Ooh, this is good."
Punish the hooded figures. Yeah,
exactly.
You can hear them in the back. Are like, "Oh, what is that?"
I did not say you can't do that, but just consider what you're doing.
Okay, I won't do it. Let's just go. Let's go to the bar.
Okay. I'll say you just ask people for directions as you're going because you know the name of the bar. You can just find your way around by talking to people, going to count it. There's not a ton of bars here, because Ruby is a pure world. There's not a lot of drinking going on.
Mm.
That place that Crow drank at was like he was the only person drinking there.
Yeah,
so.
I know. Crow accounts for maybe like 50% of the alcohol use in the world.
Yeah.
Also, all the bar designs are the same, so it's probably a monopoly.
Oh, yeah, definitely. And thank you for saying that, Opal, because that is exactly what you see when you walk in. The same exact show.
Do we see anyone with black hair sitting at the bar, pretty drunk? Grizzly voice.
Maybe with a scythe.
Although, to be determined what the voice will be now. Do we see anyone like that?
No.
Okay.
not yet.
Do we see a woman in black and red who looks like
absolutely
she may
not.
Be?
You okay? Beatrice, you do see a woman wearing a black and red dress.
What?
Go.
What?
Kane, this is your chance. Go up there.
Wait,
hold on. Moon, it's wingman time.
Wait, hold on.
Kane.
I'm talking about Raven.
You're not suggesting
that Raven is here. It was just said
that there's a black and red dress, okay?
There's a woman in a black and red dress with black long hair.
And also a bird following us around, so look at the clues.
I'm just saying, Kane sees this and immediately tries to head for the door.
Moon steps in front of Kane.
Wait. Kane. No, stop. Kane, do you know Raven? Like, Kane. Does Kane know Raven?
No, Kane. I assume Beatrice does, but Kane doesn't.
They are aware of each other. She doesn't, like, well, no,
have you met Raven? Do you know what Raven looks like?
Yes.
You've seen pictures of her?
I've met her.
This is not Raven.
Okay, all right, then we're good. That's what I wanted to make sure. Well, okay, well, for a second, Kane thought that it was and, like, tried to bolt. But then Moon stopped.
Oh my god.
You can't control what Moon does either.
But he just said that he stopped me. He got in the way.
Yeah.
Dylan, did you not just say that you're like, you stopped
me? Yeah, I step
me?
In front of Kane and say, Kane, do you see that woman? I saw you eyeing that woman over there. Now's your chance. Okay.
That's why I wasn't trying to control Moon.
Beatrice, do you approach this woman?
No.
Why not?
And he's trying to set you up for round two here.
Why don't we all go up to the bar and then King can?
Yeah, okay. We'll follow us. We'll go.
We can't make this.
Yeah, we're all going to go.
Woman is sitting at the bar.
We're going to go talk to her. Azure's going to go to the bathroom, and the rest of us are going to go talk to her. Okay.
Yeah, Azure. I'm just going to assume you won't go to the bathroom, and we'll come back to you later.
But why would we just all just randomly talk to a woman? We can't
we
just go to the bar and get
not
drink?
All, no. Just you.
Yeah, we'll go. We all go up there, but you're like,
I don't know this woman though. There's no reason for you to go up to her.
Oh my god!
Do you think she's attractive? Like,
I just walked in. Let me get a drink.
Okay, go get.
That's what we're doing.
Okay, getting drinks.
She just happens to be there.
What do you go get a drink?
Yeah, we all go up to the counter.
Yes.
Who's getting some? Who's getting some?
Do we have any money?
No.
Well, why did you need to bring that up?
Some money.
Some of you have starting. Some of you have some money, not a ton.
Oh, also, there's a show here, and we're let in for free, so maybe we get free drinks.
Oh yeah.
Also, speaking of, there's no show happening yet. You don't hear any music.
Shit.
No, that's Alex is doing. Can we ask the bartender if the show's happening?
I have returned from my shit and I have immediately ordered for 2 mugs, please.
Of what?
Too young.
Of ale. I don't know. What's the
You're
drink?
16.
Ginger ale. Ginger ale.
There's no drinking age in Ruby.
Are you looking for? Are you
there
trying to?
Like,
I'm looking for something to help me forget about today.
Aren't you too young to drink?
I tell the bartender, hello, can you give me anything that will help me forget what happened today?
Yeah, I got something for you. Here. and he puts down a big flagon in front of you, and he's like, this is a Grim Harvest. Good luck.
Nice, thanks. And I chug it.
It is very, very alcoholic.
God.
We just gotta get Azure up to speed here.
this is hard.
We just allowed Azure to drink.
I'm very in my head right now, so like I have no clue what you guys are doing. I'm just focused on drinking.
You're petting what's the name?
Russ.
Are you petting Russ?
Although, I mean, also, I don't know if they would. I don't even think they would let animals into this bar. Probably not. So, like, he's
They're
probably
too
just
afraid
outside.
To question
weirder you. Things in a remnant bar.
Yeah, fair. Okay, so let's say he's next to me. Yeah, I'm like petting him, but I'm like mumbling to him as you guys are like.
Okay. Does anyone else get alcohol?
Yeah, we all get.
Are you all getting hard liquor? Or are you getting something like just beer or something?
I'm just getting something
light. Okay.
hey bartender, what's your name?
My name's Bubba.
Bubba.
Bubba. I like that. But okay. What is there a performance later today here?
Probably. Don't really care for the music though.
Okay, I'm not talking to you anymore. Thanks.
Yeah. Fucking relatable.
Thanks, Bubba.
If you need any more drinks, just shout for me.
Okay, we'll shout for you, Bubba.
Thanks.
Oh, hey. What's your name, woman sitting at the bar here?
Yeah.
The woman who is not Fauna, sorry, I should also say that she's human. I forget that's an important distinction to make sometimes. She turns to you and like eyes you up and down a little bit. She's like, move along. You're not my type.
Oh, but what about my friend here? Shoves Kane in front of her.
Kane almost spills her drink because you shoved by Moon.
Roll a dex save, Beatrice, see if you spill your drink.
Oh, come on! Jesus Christ. I got a 9.
Okay, make a choice real fast. Are you spilling it on her or yourself?
On myself.
Okay, you spill the drink on yourself. And you see the woman in front of you kind of smirk a bit and look at you and eye you up and down. It's like, you got a funny wingman there.
Ooh, we got a meet cute happening.
Come on, you got this. You got it.
Come on, come on, come on. All of us behind you, like, whispering.
No, we're playing it cool. We turn away and are just looking out of the side of our eyes at what's happening behind
us. I can't, this is too much pressure.
Beatrice, are you going to say anything?
Oh,
ask her, is she here for the show later or something like that?
The gun show.
Yeah.
So do you come here often?
Oh, God.
Sometimes. I come here every now and then.
All right. As she's talking, Kane's just like trying to wipe the beer off her.
What brings you to this town?
Well,
tell her
about
it.
Too honest now.
Mention the Illuminati.
Don't do that. No. She's human.
I'm with my team. We're a group of hunters and huntresses. So we're just you know, doing what we do.
You look pretty strong.
Damn.
I'm not. Okay.
What's your name?
Kane. What's yours?
Irene.
Congratulations, you broke Beatrice.
No,
she's gone.
Can't do that. That's too much. I can't take it back.
Oh my god.
Take it back. That's a very pretty name.
I think Beatrice is dead. There is
she fell off the bar stool.
I did. I just slipped because the beer on the floor, because the beer spilled on me, so I just tripped over the water.
She starts laughing a bit at this, and she finds you what appears she think she from what you can tell she finds you amusing.
And I'm very embarrassed by it. So
she's still smiling and laughing.
I'm trying to be suave, and she's just I'm just trying to be save myself from the embarrassment.
She reaches out a hand to help you up. Do you take it?
Yes.
I've never seen someone this tipsy before they even start drinking.
Checks out. What can I say? Pretty girls make me nervous.
Oh.
Are you staying the night here?
Oh shit.
Hello.
Beatrice?
Are we? That's a good question.
I mean, we weren't intending to, but if
we might get murdered.
Did I lose everybody?
Oh no.
Beatrice, have you even said anything yet?
Hello?
Hello, Beatrice. Can you hear us?
Hello?
Yes.
Speaker muted? What?
She's been so overwhelmed.
Oh my god.
Oh my god. Sorry. I was like, I didn't even hear your reaction to that line. I was so nervous. And then I heard silence. Oh my god, you guys.
No, just kidding.
I said it and I regretted it, but then I didn't hear anything from you. And I was like, holy shit. Did I just like mess everything up? Oh my god. I was so scared. Anyway, sorry.
Did you hear audio?
Yeah, it just went mute. Everything went mute.
Beatrice,
okay, like,
okay. You didn't hear anything after the pretty woman?
No, after I said that, I didn't hear anything.
She responded with, "You staying the night here?"
Oh. Wait, question, because I'm not sure.
Yeah, that's what Ali
asked. Moon whispers, "We weren't intending to, but we can if you need us."
We can be your like.
I drunkenly say, "I'm staying the night here."
Azure's done. We're here.
Okay. I guess so. Yeah, we are.
Don't book a room for yourself.
Oh, very forward.
I know. this is not like the. This is not like what happened.
Ask her for money.
No. This is me talking. This is not like what happened with the nurse. Oh wow.
Oh god. What is this?
Yeah, the nurse was really bad.
Yeah, that was.
Oh, it was
good.
So yeah. Bad.
But also people were dying, so I don't know. Like this is a bar.
Yeah, that wasn't. And I was hurt. That wasn't the right moment. Anyway. Okay, sure. I'll make sure to do that. Oh my god, she is not Irene Akbar. Okay, no.
Yeah, she's Bay.
Yeah, she's Irene. Sure. I'll make sure I don't. I don't know what to say, you guys.
She just kind of smirks like, "You're cute. I'll see you tonight." And she gives you her room number.
And then I just kind of try to just take a drink. No, I got it.
We hold like, sip my
beer. No. I sip my beer, but it's apparently too strong, so I start to cough.
I have things I have to do for a little bit, but I'll be back later.
Do.
Ooh, suspicious.
You know where to find me.
Yeah, my room.
Oh, yeah. Sorry. Okay, yeah. See you there. Finger guns.
Good ending.
Finger guns, yes.
I can't.
And she finishes what she's drinking and she actually walks out of the bar. I guess she probably has some business in town. Yeah. Check, okay, check.
You're definitely going to need some security because now I'm paranoid that she's trying to trap us.
Me too.
All humans are evil.
Very paranoid.
Don't care for the trap. Defense is an important flaw.
Question. Okay, can I just say, I don't know if Irene noticed it, but I was smiling very widely.
Oh,
so
she noticed. I don't think you needed to say that.
Oh, okay. No, I'm just letting everybody know that that was what Kane was doing.
I think we all saw.
Yeah.
They saw, like, without even looking at your face.
All right. Well, all right. I just wanted to make sure that was happening. Okay. I feel like this is, like, cheating. I didn't really earn this, but I'll take it.
It was a gifted to you, okay? You needed it.
All right. Oh, man.
I think it was earned because I said I raided, you just died.
I did, didn't I? Anyway, that should be the clip. That should
and
be the clip.
Scene. Let's move on to other things for now.
And scene. So we're not role playing anymore.
Oh no! We're done with this.
Okay. We're just gonna keep drinking until the show, I guess.
Okay, we're talking to Kane about her encounter here while we're looking around for the musicians too.
Yeah. The musicians aren't here yet. But you see that people seem to be trickling in, like maybe the show hasn't been scheduled yet. And after you wait for maybe like 30 minutes, some of you get more drunk. Azure, do you continue to order Grim Harvests?
I ordered two initially, so I finished those two.
You want a third?
Do I want a third? I don't want to fall asleep for the show, so like for now,
oh, you
I'm
are
just...
not asleep. Don't worry about that.
Yeah, so... Let's say I shift to a lighter drink, but I'm still drinking. But just
fucking hammered. I just want to make sure that's clear.
Yeah, for sure. But I just don't want to get to the point where I pass out necessarily.
Okay, so can I just like start like I cut off his? Can Kane cut off his drinking because Kane doesn't want him to die of alcohol poisoning?
Yeah, I think you could do that.
Okay, so Kane, as a way to ignore any sort of discussion about what just occurred, goes full on like mama bear mode and is like, okay, I'm gonna just take care of Azure right now.
Okay, sure.
I don't need your help. You're gonna be busy anyways, so I'm fine.
No, I got you. Don't worry. Yeah, you're fine. You're absolutely fine. I'm just gonna sit next to you, kind of bring you some water. You're fine though.
Mom friend time.
When are the music people?
We're just not going to talk about anything. Nice. I'm just, Azure, how are you? You know, we're not going to talk about anything.
I don't know. I feel like I'm in a place right now where I wonder if it could just be Moke, you know, like the A at the end seems kind of frivolous at this point. You know, Team Moke would work just fine. Well, I don't know.
What are you talking about? No, we need the A. The A is the accent of the word. We can't have like a Moke. No, it's a Mocha. Like that's the
You know, it rhymes with coat, Moke. So coat, Moke. It could work. Don't
Why is the child talking about drugs?
Why is the child drunk?
Because, look, I
We're
don't...
We're bad guardians.
This was a mistake.
We're the best guardians.
To, like, believe that I could work in a team. Like, I only work well alone. I knew that, and I still went through with all the training and stuff. Figured I could change my life, but look where I am now. I'm trapped in a cage, and I can't shoot a lick.
All right. At this point, while Azure continues to drunkenly talk about something, you see the three musicians who travel walk in through the door. They walk in. And,
hey, it's the music people. Hi, music people.
And you see Dandy.
You stole my line. That's good.
See, Dandy, so drunk Azure is just Kane. Sober.
And he walks in with his violin in hand and just start playing and a really excited, a really upbeat tone. And you hear like kind of like a cheer from everyone in the bar as like just music starts to fill. Like he just comes in immediately playing music.
I'm clapping while this is happening.
People are clapping along with him and he's kind of just playing alone right now. Neither of the other two are there. The other two appear to be walking up to the barkeep, like maybe talking about like, there, the money they earn tonight, things like that. But he is just like starting to like dance around while he's playing his violin, and it's just kind of like just a fun show right now. Do you guys just kind of like get wrapped up in watching the show for now?
I definitely do.
I sure am.
Sure.
Okay.
Yeah.
I'm just gay for musicians.
Is it Dandy who's playing the violin? So it's only I turn to who's sitting beside Azure, who's like sitting close to me. Is everybody just there?
Yeah, everyone's here.
All right. So I just say like, I wonder where the others are.
The others? No, they're here. The other two walked in with him. They're just not playing.
Oh, gotcha. I thought it was just
they're discussing with him like the how they get paid tonight.
Gotcha.
I'm all just sitting like hard eyes.
So the other two are near you. But they're not they do acknowledge you, the other two, but they're discussing things with Bubba right now.
Okay.
And Danny continues to play his violin and the show continues. If you don't want to interrupt the show, I'll just give a brief overview of how the show goes. You guys aren't gonna try to interrupt anything.
At some point when Floor shows up, I shout, Flute solo.
Yeah. So
then I'm trying to be like quiet. I'm just like smiling awkwardly when Fleur looks our way, just being like, "Yeah, what can we do with him?"
As Danny keeps playing, at some point Fleur does jump in with her flute and she starts playing, and the violin keeps going but drops out a bit for the flute player to go, and then you start hearing kind of a rhythm behind it as you realize that Mist has started playing on some kind of percussive instrument. And it looks like he might be banging on something that keeps kind of ramshackled together, but it just kind of keeps a rhythm going with the music, a rhythm going to the show, and keeps the crowd in like their claps and rhythm and stuff like that. Like it just kind of keeps the whole thing moving forward with like a purpose. And it's just kind of just fun. It's not like there's anything more going on than that. It's just this fun show happening. And like Dandy starts talking to the crowd, Floor is getting into it with her flute, and some people will yell out like requests for songs they have or requests for styles and things like that. And you guys get wrapped up in it. And Moon, at some point during the conversation, you feel a tap on your shoulder.
Ooh, I turn to see who it is.
You see a dark haired man tapping on the shoulder and he says, "Come on.
Come on."
Yes.
Oh, shit.
Is it?
So I have to voice both sides of this conversation. You don't like the music?
I've been waiting here for 30 minutes. Come on.
I've been waiting here for 30. I don't know. I need to hear.
Is that really him?
Wait, what's going on?
Do I need to be raspier, Dylan? Is that what you're telling me?
I've been waiting here for 30 minutes.
I've been waiting here for 30 minutes.
No, he's not Batman. Solid Snake.
That's Batman.
What are you waiting for?
I've been waiting for you.
For me? Do I know you?
14. Come on.
Oh, come on what?
I've been waiting in the corner booth all night.
Yeah, you gave no indication that you were looking for us.
Oh my god. Are you not with... are you just some idiots who are just... Never mind. Just come with me.
Where?
To my booth.
Well, I'll come.
All of you. Bring your whole team.
Okay, I grab Azure and motion for everyone else to come.
Does everyone come with him?
Yes. Sure.
Do
I roll to see if I'm able to walk to the other side of the bar?
No, I've got you. I'm supporting you.
We'll still get Dylan.
Okay, I rolled a 16.
16, I almost said fine, but I'll just say you make it to the
yeah, bar. Yeah.
And you sit down, and this black-haired man turns to you all, and he's just like, "All right, I haven't met you guys yet. Which group are you? Who do you work with?"
We were Team Mocha.
That did not answer my question.
That's all we've got.
Wait,
we're freelance hunters.
So you don't work for Lionheart?
Who? Whomst?
Wait, is that not the right name for the guy?
No, that's it. You're right.
Okay, I thought that was
Moon's just being like, "Whomst?"
Whomst?
No. So here's some random schmucks who just... Oh my god.
We're just some random guys that wandered into an Illuminati conspiracy theory.
Jewish?
Oz, what did you do now?
Oz? Who's Oz?
Whomst?
Who the fuck are you?
That's a Whomst.
Yeah, I don't know if I mean, tubes I... every single, like every, I don't know if that works.
We don't know who any of these people are.
Didn't Kane mention some iron person?
Yeah, that's what I was trying to say. I know Ironwood. Does that name mean anything to you?
Yes, but I don't think you know what's going on. So you five just came from Ramshorn, right?
Yeah.
Maybe. Who is asking?
Well, who's asking? Yeah.
Like, literally, whomst is asking?
Whomst is asking.
Yeah, yeah. What's
my name is Crow Bronwyn.
Crow! Oh my
God, that'd be yes.
does that supposed to mean anything to us?
I don't think it means anything to you guys.
Yeah. No, I'm asking Crow.
Like a renowned hunter.
Nice to meet you, Crow.
Nice to meet you. I'm an animal, too. I'm a cat. You're a crow. I'm a cat.
I don't see any, like, bird legs.
What I'm asking here is... Okay. Let's just do a debrief. You talked to... All you need to know is I'm the good guy here.
Who do you work for?
You're the guy drinking shadowly approaching us in the bar. That's we're not believing that yet.
A red flag.
Yeah. Who do you work for? Show us some identification.
I work for the good guys. I don't know how I can prove to you that's who I am.
I think if you say you work for... Okay, this is Beatrice talking. I think if you say you work for Oz, like, Ozpin, I feel like, is a pretty renowned...
Yeah, would we know who that
also,
is?
But also,
I
Crow
think
is
we would know who Oz
but
is.
Crow is a spy, so that's why he's not willing to give that information out.
Oh, okay. But also, like, the people who went to Haven should know who Lionheart is.
Oh, right? Yeah, well, yeah. That's not me, so, yeah.
That's not me.
Harm and me.
Yeah.
Yeah. Okay. You guys would... Name... Well, I mean, maybe you're too drunk. Maybe you forget.
Do you forget who Lionheart is?
The principal, yeah.
Does the name Lionheart mean anything to you?
No, you called us Lionheart.
You no. I asked you about Lionheart if you guys don't know. It's not my job to remember that you guys know somebody.
So should we roll?
No.
For what?
To remember.
I think Harm just randomly remembered.
You guys are stupid and they need to hold your hand all the time.
No, I mean, I remember, probably.
Yeah, I definitely
remember. You didn't remember IRL. That's what I'm trying to tell you. Like, yes. You're stupid. Not...
I agree with being stupid.
He was just
Can I just say that we should... I don't think, like, saying, like, I like him, Crow saying, like, I work for Oz is, like, a bad thing. Especially, like, he needs to gain our trust.
I'm the DM. We're not discussing this.
All right, fine.
Okay. Are we good? Anyone else yell anything?
No.
Okay. All right. Long story short, I work for the guys trying to keep people like the people in Ramshorn from dying.
Which people in Ramshorn?
Yeah.
All people. All of them.
How do you know about...
Does people include Faunuses?
Yeah. Why wouldn't it?
And we have reason to believe a lot of people don't think that way in this town.
Okay, and question, why would... And all right, this is Beatrice talking again. This is me. This is my thinking. I'm trying to see if he knows about what was happening with the Faunuses in Ramshorn.
Look, here's the rundown. You guys got most of the picture. You guys found the Elder killing Faunuses in the basement. He was a shitty guy. But the bigger problem here is that he was put there by someone else to do that.
First of all, how did you know that we saw that? Have you been watching us?
I have my sources. The point is, this guy...
Whomst are they?
Is Irene one of your sources?
Does Irene work for you?
He gives you a weird...
It was just too good to be true. I have to... I'm skeptical.
He gives you a weird look, like... Hoopst? Okay.
Yeah. Crow would say.
Crow going.
Reeling back.
Anyways. And that's just what's been happening. There have been these people in these towns herding Faunuses, and they egg out the White Fang to attack them. And I think someone's been putting these people in towns to do this.
Oh, well, we met a shadowy Illuminati organization led by the guy in charge here. Does that ring a bell?
yeah, you talking about Biz?
Biz, yeah, that's him. You know Biz?
Yeah, he's the guy I've been looking at for a while.
I almost killed him just now.
That'd be bad. Don't do that.
No, that would be bad. Why?
Fizz has a lot of, let's say, what's it called when you have like a thing for when you die? A dead man switch. Sorry, he has a dead man switch.
What does that mean?
Yeah, what does that mean?
When he dies, some things will go into motion that are not
would be bad.
Good, and they will happen without him having to do anything. If he dies, they will just happen.
Oh well, good thing we didn't kill him.
We do need to get rid of him, though.
I think. Are you taking on that organization? What? Who are they? Do you know?
Well, we've been tracking them for years. They've done a lot of things all over Remnant, a lot of bad things. But wherever they go, they lead to conflict.
It's always the rich people, man.
A lot of Grimm show up, and it's not good.
Have you had to deal with gun turrets coming out of the ceiling?
And
cages coming out of the ground?
I have dealt with a lot of things. Maybe. I get drunk a lot.
Same, buddy. And you got a nice flask, by the way. Can I mention that?
I can't believe. Okay, this is just me. I can't believe the kid of the group is an alcoholic. Yeah,
this is. We're bad supervisors.
I'm the kid. Like, you really should stop him from doing that. As he takes talking. from his.
Yeah.
Right.
Do you have any concrete details on this organization?
I don't know if I want to get you involved if you're not working with Lionheart.
Whoops. Oh, that's right. You mentioned it earlier.
And I'm just going to assume that Haley and Allie reacted and told everybody that he's the head of the other place.
Oh, yeah. I think we're invested at this point.
Yeah. I mean, at least we're the faces of whatever's against
them. They're going after us, so we're involved.
So I think, I think it's too late to not be involved.
All right. You don't have to convince me anymore. I do need some help. I am alone right now, and...
Which, by the way, your boss must, like, think you're quite capable to just send you out on this mission alone.
It's more that I work best alone, but sometimes you need a little more firepower.
I work best alone, too.
What about Russ?
He's lying.
Yeah, Alex, you literally have a dog.
Yeah.
Well, he is friendly and cares about me, not like you people.
Aww.
All right, here's the deal. Are you guys staying the night?
We are staying the night, and one of us has room accommodations already.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Well, we can get rooms. I can get you a room too for you guys to stay in. But we'll plan tonight, and we will meet somewhere tomorrow. And I have some ideas for what we can do.
Well, it's not that late. We could keep talking.
No. He's implying that you're going to keep talking, then you'll stay here.
Okay.
Are we planning on, like, kidnapping this dude or holding him somewhere?
What dude? Crow?
Who?
No. The, what's his name? Biz.
Biz?
Are we going to take care of Biz?
No. We have to work up to him. If we take him out before everything else is in place, it'll just kill more people.
Oh, yeah, I guess we should tell you. There's some, like, shadowy invisible figures who shot arrows at us. That sound familiar?
Yeah.
Oh.
Very.
That wasn't
Who are they?
I've been trying to figure that out. They're very, very secretive.
Doesn't seem like you know much.
Question. Do you know if... Are these shadowy figures working for Biz? Or is Biz working for them?
That's kind of what I've been trying to figure out. At first, I thought they were working for him, but
we've met Biz. I don't think they're working for him.
Yeah, that's more what I've come to. It seems that they tell people they work for him, but I think it's the other way around. I think they're people I've been searching for a while. I can't, but their identities, don't really know them. They just show up. They kind of cause havoc, keep things pointed in the direction of conflict, like I was saying. And I think they might also have a hand in what's pushing the White Fang to go to specific locations.
Look, they know our faces. Like, at least Biz does.
Yeah, they definitely...
They've seen us. Is that going to...
Oh, yeah.
How much can we help you? If, I mean, we can't necessarily go super secretive.
That's why
Our, and that's not really our style. We kind of go big or go home.
That's not why we're not going to. You guys are going to go big, kids.
Yay. Okay.
You guys, we're, if they know your faces, they think you guys are the threat. You guys are going to draw them out, and I'm going to go take care of some other business while you guys are distracting them.
Is, but, what's a, you need to tell us more about you. Why should we trust you?
I've seen a lot in my, I've seen a lot. I'm one of the best huntsmen in probably all of Remnant.
Show some.
Show us some.
Show some.
We're in a bar, man.
Doesn't,
I don't think you need prompting like, to start a bar fight, Crow. I feel like you would readily do that.
No, but okay. Question: as Crow has like an ID, like hunts people have like remember like in Volume 6 when those like two people.
But
like,
what are you trying to say, Beatrice?
No, I'm just saying all Crow has to do is show him his
but
ID.
But Crow like, is a spy, so he doesn't want to show us his ID. That's kind of the point.
Well, like, he could be a spy, but he's still, like, a well-known huntsman is what I'm saying. Like, he could be like, look, I'm a huntsman. Like, you can trust me.
I had assumed that he showed you that when he said his name.
Oh, okay, gotcha.
Tell us, where's your team? Did you have a team?
One day. Or, I used to.
Who comprised your team?
That is not a... You'd give me a lot drunker to talk about that.
Okay, let's do it.
You'd have a lot drunker?
Yep.
Do you order
another round
from Bubba?
Yep. Bubba, hit us up.
Hey, Bubba.
Crow kind of smirks, and like the rest of the night kind of just goes by in a blur. You're drinking.
So we don't get any planning done.
No. You have a plan, and you discussed it before you got too drunk. And the main plan is you're going to be going to do some. He left the details to you guys to decide, but you're going to do something somewhat overt that you think the Illuminati people will not like, and that will hopefully draw them to you. And once they're drawn to you, Crow will act on in some way to try to deal with Biz.
Okay.
And that's
before the night's at, are you about to finish the night?
Well, Beatrice has a place to go.
Yes.
Yeah.
No. But before I have, can I ask Crow something?
Yeah, sure.
Okay, so this is like after like we have more drinks in us. I'll like kind of be like a little bit be like now that I have the liquid courage, I'll be like, so do you know Raven? Are you related to Raven Brown by any chance?
Yeah, my sister.
Oh, okay. Well,
you know her.
That's the thing. How do you fucking know who she is?
She's just a stalker. That's why.
Yeah,
apparently.
I'm letting Beatrice be a stalker because she. I think, you know what I think it
no.
is? I think Beatrice thinks, like, a player is just a stalker. And that's why she's like,
no!
Kane is so good at hooking up with the lady.
No! Oh my god. Okay, can I... This is where I give a little bit of exposition.
Go ahead.
Okay.
Well, one of the first missions, I kind of came across her band of bandits in one of my first missions with Ironwood. And let's just say we didn't see eye to eye. I may have burned their camp. A little bit,
yeah. And, Raven doesn't really see eye to eye.
She's not a fan. So I kind of, anytime I see a lady in black and red, I kind of tend to run at first.
Yeah.
So I just want to know where you stand on this, because she's not the greatest person, and if you're related to her, I don't know if trusting you is smart.
There's not many people that Raven's talked to that like her, and I'm one of them. No, I'm not one of them. Sorry. Okay. She's not very agreeable.
Yeah.
But anyways, and as the conversation goes on, he mentions a couple targets you could go for. He said he mentions that there's a town to the north of here that is kind of meets all the criteria of the other three towns, and he said that there's someone there who appears to be doing things to Faunus. He says he's not 100% sure what, but he's heard about a large number of Faunus showing up dead there. And he said that'd probably be a good place for you to start looking, and hopefully that will draw out the people that you're trying to distract.
Cool.
And that's kind of what he gives you. You guys can either act on that or not, but that is the direction Crow thinks is the best action.
Okay, we'll discuss in the morning.
Yeah, and I'm
in
not,
the meantime...
Drunk time.
So Kane is a place to be.
Yeah, we gotta send Kane off.
Okay. You guys, and you guys all just say that you guys get a room or rooms, whatever you want.
Can I sleep outside?
Sure. I will not stop you from sleeping in an alleyway.
I want to use my Russ as my blanket.
Okay.
Do that in the room too.
No, I don't want to be around you people right now.
He also grew up on an island. He's probably fine with it.
So yeah, are you guys? Are you the rest of you three going to get different rooms?
Sure.
Sure.
Okay. We could share two rooms to save money.
Okay.
For sake of D&D argument.
Okay. And then Kane, do you head up to the room that was given to you?
Yep.
What?
Yep. Okay. Yep. I'm just trying to be as inconspicuous as possible, trying to head there and not make a big deal out of it.
We all pushed you to talk to her, so.
Okay. So you walk up the stairs, down the hallway, and you walk to the last door in the hall to the room that was given to you, and you check the door handle. It is open. It's unlocked. Do you enter?
So I didn't unlock it.
It was just unlocked.
Can I knock on the door and go, hello, pretty person? Hello?
Oh, yeah, you didn't even get her. Oh, no, you did get her name.
Beatrice, very something.
Okay, before I knock, can I kind of, like, do a check, and see if I hear anything?
Sure.
Okay. All right, here we go. Ooh, okay, it was a sharp. I got a 14.
You don't hear anything inside.
Okay, well, I'm going in.
Okay. You open the door, and you see candles and rose petals leading to the bed.
No one's up. Oh, fuck.
It's very romantic for, like, someone I just
go met. Ahead. What do you do? Do you walk to the bed?
I mean, I thought we were just going to cut to black.
No. I'm not going to show anything. Don't worry about that. Just, are you going to the bed?
Wait, but is someone on the bed?
No one's in the room.
How far away are the rest of us?
You guys are.
No, I take my my jacket off. I don't want
to
.
As you start taking off your jacket and you turn to whatever to hang it up, everything goes black for you. You are knocked unconscious.
I knew it.
What? I knew it. She was evil.
Great. You made Irene a villain. Why would you do that?
Of course, she's a villain.
No. Wait, I missed it. What happened again?
Kane just went unconscious.
Irene's bad news.
Beatrice entered the room given to her by Irene, and she found something weirdly romantic, and she kind of just walked in, took off her jacket, and when she turned the direction, she got.
Maybe Irene is just really kinky.
The head and got knocked out.
I still trust her.
I mean, even if she kills me, I'll still trust her. So.
Okay. I think this is a good place to stop for now.
What a cliffhanger.
That was an insidious setup to.
Yeah, I know. You're like, no, it's going to be simple. I was like, wait, this is too easy. It's like, no. I felt bad for you. Okay. Then I go in and I just get knocked out. Thanks, Andy.
Yeah, no problem, Beatrice.
Thanks. Like, you didn't have to name her Irene. You could have just, been like, her name.
Well, in hindsight, all the signs were there that it was too obvious.
She was bad.
Well, in hindsight, I was still recovering from the reveal of the name Irene.
Oh, yeah.
And everybody was pushing this to happen.
I was neutral in this. Thank you very much.
Oh, my God.
I was the one who was taking care of you when drunk. The least you can show is some sort of worry.
Okay. Well.
Whatever happened to Floor? I want to talk to her.
Who?
Floor. Where's Floor?
Before you go to bed? Oh, do you want to?
Where's Delacour?
I guess you guys can do stuff. Like, you. Beatrice is knocked out.
We already went to bed.
Yeah, I think you guys went to bed. I think we're a little late.
I mean, I think. I'm outside, but like
I think he's laying with Russ, and he's just like trying to sit up. He's like, I want to talk to Floor.
Yeah,
and he's
like not actually going. And I just like shout her name, Floor.
Do you have a thing for Floor?
Mm, I think so.
Nobody responds to you, Alex. I'm sorry. Yeah. You hear playing from inside the bar, but no one comes out to you.
We'll get them to help us next time.
Yeah, eventually I pass out while I'm still mumbling to myself. So. Yeah.
You all get a full rest. You all your aura recharges, but I think it's just Alex. Oh, and Dylan had lost 1 point of aura.
Oh, question. Do I lose aura because I got hit or no?
This was a strange thing. You didn't actually lose any aura from this.
Okay. Okay.
It was a kind blunt blow to the head. She's nice.
All right. So I'm just saying.
Would you say it was a love tap?
Yeah, it's a love tap. Exactly.
She's just really kinky, guys.
It's fun.
Yeah. No, we're just going to, we're going to cut to next week and Beatrice is like tied to the bed or something.
Yep. Exactly.
Yeah. Nothing to worry about here. There's nothing wrong here.
I don't think so.
Okay. Anyways, that was this session. We will hopefully get another one at some point. Hopefully sometime.
There has to be a conclusion to that story.
Yeah. But you can find out all the info on this podcast at overlyanimated.com. You can join us on Discord to text chat about animation at overlyanimated.com/Discord. You can support us via Patreon at patreon.com/overlyanimated. Thanks to all our current patrons, especially our patron of the podcast, James, a.k.a. Ironwood, which is very...
He's not showing up though. Just Crow.
And thanks as always to, well, Beatrice sent a text to him that he never replied to.
Not replying, but yeah.
And thanks as always to our patron executive producers, John, Ryan, Steve, Alex, and Hugh. Yeah, this was really fun. Hopefully
we open up next week with a close up of the phone on the bed buzzing. Ironwood's like, "Where are you?" texting Kane.
Oh,
yeah, that's the post credit scene.
Yeah.
That's the post-crisis, exactly.
Anyways, thanks for listening, guys. We'll listen to you next time.
We'll listen to you next time.
Talk to you next time.
I guess that goof is staying in. Thanks for listening, guys. We'll see you next time. Bye.
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 Bye.